Well, hello and welcome. If you've just joined the stream, we are about to start a game between O and RR. The current moment. Just waiting for two more players to join into the team, into the lobby, and we should be able to progress afterwards. And just one more player to join. We should be on our way pretty soon. Right then, apparently last player has done and is loading into the client, and we should be able to proceed from there on. My co-caster for today, Curtain Gaming 2 ID, is actually Zenz.
My casting duo. Looks like RR is looking for 2 minutes for time.
Should be starting really soon. All the other games have already started, and looks like both teams are ready, and we're about to jump into the game right now. Captain's mode. Radiant is Team Owl, and the Dire is RR. Coin toss happening now from the admin. And winner gets the pick to be Radiant. Are both picking head, that's a bit of a problem right there. And RR gonna go with their Radiant team, so I can just swap them over, thankfully, in the Reborn client. I thought there was a command to switch them over, actually. Could have sworn there was one. It's about here. Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, hello. Welcome to Curtain Gaming Championship Dota 2
game against Ao and RR.
Co-casting with me is Zenz. Hello, Zenz.
Hello, Inferno. How are you?
I'm doing good. We've been casting since 11 o'clock in the morning.
10 seconds remaining.
Exactly. So I was casting on Counter-Strike Global Offensive.
It's definitely a new experience, as we move into the picks and ban. Watch me whip is the captain for the Radiant team, and they've chosen to take out the Le Shrek. What's the meta game like now, Zenz?
A very favorite team now is Monkey Business. As you see, Arise, famous magnet. Recently, he was doing a 5-man rampage, the famous rampage. But the meta here seems like it's still going on with Le Shrek and Queen of Pets.
Do you think that we're gonna see Lina somewhere in this game?
5 seconds remaining. Well, I'm not surprised there's a Lina too.
Oh, Broodmother being taken out right there.
Dire team ban.
And the immediate response from Boy Boy is to remove the Undying. So this team Lina. Fight meta right now. Oh, there you go. That's the Lina that we predicted, and immediately with the Earthshaker Tusk. It looks a little Radiant bit like Team Secret, doesn't it, Zenz?
Yeah. Are we gonna see a Techies game here? What do you think?
Oh dear, oh dear. Techies. Now that will be an interesting hero to see being played here at CGC, but nope. They've gone with a Darkseer. Very good offlaner.
I think Darkseer will be a very good with a combination Light Stray. I must 2 seconds time will be a very good.
Well, your mic is breaking off every now and then. I think possibly your open mic settings could be double checked.
Reserve time.
Alright, I'll check it.
Anyway, moving on with the picks and bans, Alina into Darkseer for the picks on the Radiant side. That sets up the Vacuum Light Strike Array combination, and they've taken out the Phantom Lancer to try to avoid Radiant the Dire team picking up a hard carry. And Dire has responded with a Luna ban. Zenz, are you with us?
10 seconds remaining.
Looks like he's not joined us just yet at the moment. Well, interesting about Darkseer is six. Hello, hello, Zenz. Welcome back. We're just going over some of the patch notes. The Darkseer has got a slight buff. The Iron Shell duration is now 5 seconds longer, and the duration for the Wall of Replica is at the maximum 45 seconds instead of scaling upwards. And Zenz, what do you think of the all melee lineup so far right now for the Dire?
Well, I think if the Radiant team would pick up X, then it will be some trouble for the Dire team, because all it will be a serve for the Dire Radiant team.
I do agree with you. And they've gone for a Dazzle pickup here on the side of RR, possibly looking to play around with the Shadow Weave as well as the Wall of Illusions and the massive damage they can cause. Interesting thing about Dazzle, he's one of the few supports whose damage is mostly physical. Let's double check, let's see. Poison Touch is physical.
10 seconds remaining.
And as is Shadow Wave is also physical. And Weave reduces armor, which affects physical. So
very, very interesting. Do you think it's gonna be a mid Lina, Zenz?
Winter Wyvern. Yep, we're gonna see a mid Lina and also a Medallion Dazzle.
Ah, Medallion Dazzle, that's true. That just amplifies the minus armor even more. Winter Wyvern, the pickup here coming up from Ao. Also very popular in the meta. And I think it's a good counter to all the physical damage that might come out of the hard carry from Team RR.
Yep, exactly.
And look at that Bounty Hunter ban from the team of the Radiant. They've removed Bounty Hunter. I think it was Cloud9, or rather the X-Cloud9, with Pilai Dai and his roaming bounty hunter made it really, really famous. Or was it Bone 7?
Yep, he was Bone 7 with Dagger.
Witch Doctor!
We are seeing a Witch Doctor sense.
Dire team ban.
This is very, very interesting. I think Team RR is going for a purple lineup. And notice the ultimate death ward is physical damage.
Well, it seems like the Radiant team are lack of a carry. Who do you think the carrier might be?
Could possibly be a Juggernaut, seeing that the Gyrocopter's already been taken out. Either that, or they might actually try and go a Drow Ranger. However, one thing to note, Team RR does lack a tank, so to speak. They have picked up 4 Intelligence Heroes, whereas on the side of the Dire, they've got Tusk, which is fairly tanky, and Earthshaker, which has got a healthy HP pool as well. And Dire Radiant have removed both the Bone Fletcher. Was that the old name for Clinks? Bone Fletcher. Was that the Dota 1 name?
Yep, that's the old name.
Dota 1 name. Oh, man.
Yep, Bone Fletcher.
good old days.
yeah.
Anyway, next patch, maybe Arc Warden is coming out. What do you think about that? Last pick up here coming out from the Dire. They've got a fairly good lineup, so to speak. Possibly looking for a versatile mid hero that can help carry the game in the early game until Anti-Mage enters with his Battle Fury, possibly minute 18, minute 20 with the Manta style. And Invoker, Pudge, all up for grabs. Very popular pub heroes, but it really remains to see what the composition of the Dire team is. They've got a minute and 16 on the reserve time to select their pick, so there's plenty of time for Boy Boy to actually think around and decide what angle he wishes to take this. The heroes on the Radiant side are fairly squishy. Not too big of HPs, but they've got tremendous burst damage. So the pick from Boy Boy for the mid lane. Hello Zens, welcome back.
Welcome. Yeah, I'm back. Well, it seems like there was some slightly issues with the microphone, so sorry about that.
You sound sick, Zens.
Yeah, not really.
Well, that's a big shame. Anyway, as mentioned before, 30 seconds left on the pickup for Boy Boy. And possibly looking to pick up a... What other mid heroes do we have that still remains in the metagame? They've gone with a
Puck. It's gonna be a Puck.
So Puck, again, very, very versatile in the early game. Good silence, good AoE, and good ultimate if placed properly. However, Dragon Knight is the response coming out here from the Radiant team. But just to go over on that Puck, Puck loses its versatility as soon as the teams, the heroes start picking up their BKBs. And the laner, if it's a farming laner, will definitely be able to afford a BKB. Dragon Knight also 100% going into that BKB as since we are in game. Shall we start with the introductions of the team? I'll do the Dire team, if you don't mind.
Prepare for battle.
Hello, my friend Zens, are you there? Anyway, moving on with the introductions. We've got Boy Boy over on the Puck, Gravity onto the Tusk, Sky playing his Earthshaker, Bang Bang Bang, or Bang X3 onto the Winter Wyvern, and of course, the stand-in player. Not sure what to call him, let's just call him Question Mark for now, as they are straight away pushing to contest the Bounty Runes. And over onto the Radiant team. now watch me sip. Hey Zens, you there?
Yeah, I'm there.
Right, do you mind introducing...
Yeah, what's up, man?
Introduce to us the Radiant team, man. To battle.
Oh, you already introduced the Dire team.
I just introduced the Dire team.
Well, you know, Radiant... Alright, no, Radiant team, which is Ranger. We have now Watch Me Nene with the... pick up with the Darkseer, and also G-Mokoko, which I would say is a Brother Devils with Linas, and also Pen with the Dark Dazzler. You are reported Witch Doctor, and also now Watch Me with Dark. Dragon Knight.
So it looks like the Earthshaker has just warded off at the magic bush. Is that the magic bush ward? No, it's not. It's not exactly the magic bush ward. Well, let's see if it blocks off the spawn camps here for the Radiant team.
Is the camera on your side?
The camera is on my side, Zenz.
Alright, good. It's cool.
It's cool, it's cool. Alright, Zenz, what do you think about this? The Lina is going for the safe lane, and the Dragon Knight has actually moved over to the mid lane.
Well, it seems like they want to prioritize on the early stage of the game, getting Lina farm up and get an early Usurper and get a mid control game. Which I think is a very good tactic.
That's a quick pause coming out from the anti-mage. Perhaps the admin would like to see what's the reason for the pause. Oh, no, it's just starting to resume straight away. Darkseer against anti-mage. The Darkseer can actually harass with the Iron Shell, but once anti-mage gets levels in the mana break and starts to just eek into the mana pool of the Darkseer, it's going to be very difficult for the Darkseer to actually keep casting his spells. Fairly mana intensive, 70 mana for a 400 pool hero. And the anti-mage is doing just fine over here at the top lane. Leading the last hits with 7 last hits and 5 denies over in the mid lane. The Puck and the Dragon Knight fairly even, although you'd expect the Puck to actually perform better seeing that he is a ranged hero. And yet they've spotted out that there was a ward indeed that has blocked off the easy pull cam.
Well, Lina having a 7 creep with a 2D knight. A very good safeline control here on the Raiden team.
Well, yes, that's true. The Earthshaker, however, is getting his levels.
What do you think about Earthshaker on the offlane, on the Dire side?
Earthshaker on the Dire side. It's definitely a very interesting hero. I'd actually put the Tusk there over the Earthshaker.
Yeah, I mean, according followed by the meta, we have Tusk here with our offlane.
Looking at the Earthshaker, he's looking to farm using Fissure for his last hits, and it's definitely not helping him. He's got to use Clarities every now and then, but he does have enough gold for his brown boots if he so chooses it. He is level 3, so compared to the Darkseer over the top lane. What level is the Darkseer? I'm very sorry, I seem to be the cameraman for the casting, and you seem to be in control of what heroes we see and what levels they are at.
Oh, I see.
We need to possibly rework this before the next game starts.
So you'll be moving the camera and I'll be the hero, is it?
That's correct. You'll be moving the camera. I'll be moving the camera and you are the one with all the work to do on clicking on the heroes and seeing what items they have.
Alright, thank you for the information, Inferno.
That's definitely not an easy thing to do. Oh, it looks like Lina has reconnected into the game. And again, going with its last hits and denies. No. Go. No. RR is not ready. Anyway, going back to these last hits and denies, you can see that the anti-mage is over with 19 last hits and 13 denies. He's really, really hurting that Darkseer.
Wow, going for the mid, there seems like they are going for the aggressive mid here.
I think that they should be putting more pressure on the Earthshaker. They shouldn't let him just farm up so freely. As does that Dragon Knight have an Orb of Venom? Oh, my eyes are seeing things. Why was I seeing? No, he doesn't. My eyes are seeing things.
Oh, Inferno.
Oh man, you probably need rest. Anyway,
Right now, the ward vision over on the radiant side, overlooking that bottom rune. The dire side is overlooking general pull direction, and they've got one aggressive ward as well from the radiant to see any rotations coming in that looks to gank the Darkseer. So Darkseer has a good vision over on where the Winter Wyvern is and should be playing this one safely. Shouldn't really be caught at all. Invisibility.
Well, is it possible that I follow your camera, Inferno?
Oh, no problem. I definitely think it's no problem at all. And oh, look at this. Gravity is coming in with an Invis rune. Doesn't have too many spells available. I don't think the Radiant had vision of when he picked up the invisibility rune. Oh, good jonks there from the Breathe Fire. And if Tusk wants to do something, it should be now. No. No, no, they're not going to do it. They do have creeps, but it's not enough. And, looks like that Invis rune is just going to be wasted.
Wow. Dragon Knight seems to be have a very good map already. You know that someone's missing Slight Tusk, playing safe and hugging the tower.
That's very, very good map awareness by him. Indeed, he noticed that the Tusk wasn't appearing anywhere. Oh, pinging out the stack for me, thank you. Double stack going on here at the hard camp in the Radiant side. Possibly for the Dragon Knight to farm once his Breathe Fire has reached level 4. And Gravity is this babysitting boy. He's just babysitting boy in the mid lane. What do you think about this? It's taking some of the EXP away from the Puck, and Puck definitely does need the EXP.
And so do Tusk. Tusk really should get a early level 6 in order to get an early gank in a mid stage.
I do agree
so that they
you.
Can get a mid game control.
Definitely, definitely. And well, they're looking to stack the medium camp once more, and they will actually succeed. Well done. Engagement over onto the bottom rune. Ice shards coming out onto Pain. Snowball as well as the Illusory Orb. Getting the first blood for the Puck. Dragonite comes in, and the Dire team will disengage. Poor positioning, maybe, from the Shadow Priest from Dazzle. What do you think about that, then?
Yeah, it was a very bad positioning considering that was having a ward on the bottom river there. Getting a kill, having a ward is not a really good sign.
To agree with you, it's possibly looking to reward it as that ward will expire in. Oh, and I just as I say that, it does expire in a few seconds. So there you go. 50 lost hits on the anti mage. He's got 1,700 gold in his bank, and is definitely well on his way to his Battle Fury. What do you think of the new Reborn client, Zenz? Do you think it's better than the Source One engine?
Well, seems like everyone's commenting it's a very bad. Well, personally, I think it's a. It depends on how you look at it. As for me, I don't really not say like it, but I would say it's an okay.
Yeah,
because traffic has been increased.
It's definitely not bad, isn't it? So lots of room of improvement there.
Well, this also happens to Source One before. Learn from mistakes, yeah. Let's just hope that there's no bugs in this game.
Yeah. that's true. Gravity and Boy, again, moving on to this bottom rune. They're really getting the rune game really well, but they can see there's Dragon Knights already at the top rune. And the ward spots the haste being popped, so Anti-Mage should really start to move away right now. But Winter Wyvern, he's still gonna fight. He saw that coming. Now, the stun will come up. Vacuum as well will confirm the kill against the Winter Wyvern. As bottom lane, Lina isn't taken, but right now, Anti-Mage is in trouble. TP support coming in with the Earthshaker. No, it's a Tusk coming in. And I didn't catch the bottom lane kill. What happened there, Zenz?
Well, getting a safe lane kill by Tusk with a snowball with Park, with Izzo up and also running.
Oh, Dragon Tail coming onto the anti-mage. Very low HP, survives. On how many HP is that? Oh, he does die to the poison. Eventually, Shallow Grave coming on, but really, HP is still very, very high on the side of the Dragon Knight. So that's a really good kill against the anti-mage. He was getting so close to his Battle Fury, and now they just
stop him completely.
I did miss the anti-mesh Q. Tell me what happened. What did actually happen?
Right, so what happened over top? That he got a bit aggressive. His blink was not ready, as it seems, and the Dragon Tail just came up because the Dragon Knight was in his ulti form. So the Dragon Tail had good range on him, and he just got caught. Plain and simple. He thought he survived and he blinked away, but really the poison from the Dragon Knight was lethal and managed to kill him. He could have bought his boots to spend his gold, but he didn't do so, and he lost about 400 to 350 unreliable gold there.
Simicide.
Oh, Surgeon coming on the Darkseer. Anti-Mage will respond. Arctic Burn coming in from the Winter Wyvern. Goes for the ulti, but the Shallow Grave is just in time. And right now, they've actually casted Surgeon. Oh, but the Ice Charge really, really well predicted there by Gravity. We'll take the kill for the Darkseer. And the Tusk is slowly finding his levels and money.
Well, they really went for aggressive. Darkseer went to search himself just to get a secure kill for empty mesh, but a very good backup from the Dire team, and also Tusk with a very immediate response to top lane.
Baited.
Exactly.
Puck 1,500 gold. Negus Snowball's gonna come in against the Dragon Knight, but Shallow Grave does not. Echo Slam is already there, level 6 already onto the Earthshaker. Pain will run away with 5 HP, but no, Puck gets the last hit. Winter Wyvern is caught by the Puck ultimate and will fall. And that's a double kill for the Puck. And just as I say that, he's already 150 gold away from his Blink Dagger if he so desires it.
Dwarf Minix Mask with Pyrotret and Daggers. It's really a very high skill standard.
And bottle too, not bad at
more
all.
Like, Radiant's top tower is yeah, under 11 minutes mark.
So the Anti-Mage having 3,000 gold in his bank. I wonder why he's not spending his gold. As a backstab is coming in? No, I'm seeing him. Why isn't the Anti-Mage spending his gold yet, Zenz? Any ideas?
Dire's bottom tower is under investment attack. Maybe.
Investment.
For buybacks.
Well, that's quite possible actually. 79 last hits, and we've been ignoring the Lina for quite some time, and she's managed to get up to 71 last hits. And she's got her Yules already. Is that her Yules already completed, Brandon?
Yes, yep. Yules chapters complete in 12 minute marks with Safland.
Well, that's not too bad, I think, considering he died once.
Keep taking the skirt.
Smoke Gang coming in. Pain's gonna get caught. He's the only one. Smoke Gang complete. Well, that's not so bad. You know, they smoke and they only get a support. So I think the Radiant will be happy with that. Unless you report it, it's got no. Ultimate comes up onto the Dragon Knight. Ice Charge as well. He will break the call and get stunned as the Walrus Punch does come in against him. The Earth Shaker is all the way forward. We'll get a Fissure onto three heroes, as a matter of fact. The Snowball will go onto you, report it. As the Darkseer goes out with his Vacuum. Puck will blink forward and get the kill with the Silence. And the Lina will fall as well. Good jump there for the Puck. Gets his Mango off to get that extra bit of mana. And the Lina will survive with just 5 HP. And as we say that, Zenz, it looks like the Anti-Mage, the Anti-Fun hero, has completed his Battle Fury. No treads though, interestingly.
Seems like he wants to give a surprise Battle Fury brought to the Radiant ship.
Oh yeah.
Or maybe he saved it in case he there was not enough gold using the game and he might be going for Manta instead of Battle Fury.
Oh, that's actually a really, really good point there. And looks like they're already going to get a tower. There it is. Anti-Mage gets a tower. He's not intimidated at all. He's going to try to go forward for the kill. No, he'll go back. That coconut just bouncing back and forth. Oh, Punk blinks forward. Wallace punch immediately onto the Lina and she just disappears from the map just like that. And the Dragon Knight will escape even though he does have the Arctic Burn on him. And the Winter Wyvern will have Cold Embrace.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
It looks like All Gaming is playing very aggressively, looking at the ward, controlling the Radiant teams.
Oh, so well, onto the Dragonite, Water Sponge immediately, Earthshaker is the ultimate!
It's 4 players, it's got a 3-4 hit score as well, the triple Dragonite left, but Blink gets killed, a triple kill for the Pug.
And Alina already died earlier, that's something like a team wipe. Sense, what's happening?
Well, Over Gaming seems like they're very confident with this game, they just go for it. They know that they can pick up the Radiant team.
Well, we were talking about the lanes, how the lanes didn't look what you would consider the meta with a dual lane mid with a Tusk and Puck, but they're making it work so well. The early levels on the Earthshaker has really helped them. Getting an Echo Slam early on in team fights has just annihilated all the supports on the side of the Radiant.
Seems like picking up Earthshaker with a very early stash levels is a very critical stash on the mid game.
Oh, that's true. And then they're looking to pressure that bottom tier 1 tower. Looking at the net worth, the Puck is leading with 7,400 and the Anti-Mage close behind, 7,200. They're just looking to clear the stacks now, they're just looking to protect this Lina. What item do you think they're going to rush on the Lina next? Perhaps Power Treads or Arcanes?
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
I don't think they were going to prioritize on upgrading the boots. Due to he has an U Scepter, increase some movement speed percentage, maybe go for a Blink Dagger for a utility stage.
Oh, that's a really good point, actually. However, one thing to note, since the Lina has already gotten a Yule Scepter, we haven't really seen it being put to use yet. They haven't really gone on a smoke yet for the Radiant team and try to catch the Anti-Mage off guard farming. And right now, the Anti-Mage is farming freely and he's very, very close to getting his next item already with... Pardon, already with 700 gold bank after the last purchase, has gone for Aquilas. And they're just gonna pressure the bottom tier 2 tower with no real respawn. They're looking to trade, but I don't think the trade's worth it.
Dire's structures are fortified.
I mean, you lose Dire's your bottom tier 2 tower, you lose control of your jungle, you lose the tower that you can TP to Roshan. And it looks like the TP is coming in from the Earthshaker. Earthshaker does have Blink Dagger. Gets official out. Will be used up into the air. The Puck does come in and gets a really good silence. Cold Embrace and Winter Scare coming up from the Winter Wyvern. Vacuum into the Wall of Replica, but there's so little damage over on the side of the Radiant. They can't finish off the heroes and the Dire. Instead, Auskai finally falls down to the Iron Shell and Puck gets a wicked sick with the Winter Wyvern getting a double kill and two kills there for the Puck. There was just no damage from the Radiant team. All the heroes on the Dire side were low, but the Radiant team couldn't finish them off.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Well, Dire team knows that the Radiant team have a very weak in their they are very weak in their HP. So they just like go for it, you know. They know that they can secure the kill. A very good combination there within the Dire team.
Also, you'd expect the Darkseer to at least have some components. Oh, and as I say that, his buckler does come online. And looking to build into the mechanism. As the Dragon Knight will be trying to farm up this mid lane. No real item progression, don't you think, Zenz?
On who?
Over on the carry heroes of the Radiant. The Dragon Knight is...
Well, they're not that...
Sorry?
You see, Radiant team, not the Dire team, has been sticking around.
And as I say that, they're looking to catch the Anti-Mage off guard. Light Strike, Air Raid combination will come out, and the Laguna Blade, but not much damage due to the spell spell shield of the anti-mage, but then again, that's five heroes taking so much time to just kill one on the side of the Dire. And finally, they go in the smoke of their own self. And pinged out by the laner. No, nothing too important there, but they are prepared to jump in on this mid lane, but there are no heroes of the Dire team that are alone.
Well, Lina's Usurper has not been used recently because they know that Dire team has been sticking around, except for AM, to get a solo. Radiant team has a solo pickup, so they just stick around.
Now, both teams jockeying for position over here in the bottom lane. Sky, bang, 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 as well as Gravity just hiding in the trees right there, possibly hoping that the Radiant team will take the bait, as four heroes of the Dire team converge now. And requesting a pause here from the side of the Dire.
Oh. Is that a very high ping?
Let's see how it's going on so far. Nope, I do not know how to check in the Reborn client. And spoiler alert, we've got one game already finished. It's Roberto plus 5 against Go to Sleep. That's an 18 minute game. Roberto plus 5 has won in 18 minutes. And oh dear, this is not good. This is not good. DK is AFK.
Seems like. What?
No.
Oh.
Are you ready to watch a DK disappear? And he's gone.
Oh, melted.
Godlike on the puck, blinks forward, catches two. And the snowball comes in, bringing the rest of the heroes into the fight as well. Yulsum's on the lane out to himself, vacuum from the dark here. Echo Slam from Sky and gets Misha as well, but the mana void is there. Oh my god. Like I said before, all the heroes on the side of the Dire are so low, but there's just no damage on the side of the Radiant. They can't finish them off.
They are playing like a textbook Dota. Execution is perfect in a Dire team.
Execution is indeed perfect. They know when they have the advantage and they are pressing it hard. They're now knocking on the door of the bottom base right now of Radiant. And they're looking to getting the rack. I think they'll be able to get the rack, really. There's no way that the Radiant team can defend this.
Well, Radiant team can't contest this rack.
Oh, Snowball coming in onto very aggressively onto the Dragon Knight. Does get the Dragon Tail over into Gravity, but Pain right now has been silenced by the Pucks spaceship. It's a massacre. We've lost four heroes inside the Radiant and will to be five heroes. Self-use, but it's not going to save her right now. And the last hit from the Anti-Mage will ensure the kill. That's the bottom barracks gone. Is there any way back from the Radiant team? It's now 27 to 5, Zenz.
31 minutes max, where there's been a lot of team wipe around Radiant team. I think there might be a slightly chance to come back, but I can't think of a way how they would come back in this situation, considering they lost two racks now.
Oh dear, oh dear. Doesn't look good at all, doesn't it, Zenz? An anti-mage. What items does he have, Zenz? Seem to have lost my co-caster. Let's manually check his items on the long way. The anti-mage has gotten his Manta style. And Reborn has a problem, according to the spectator.
That's Zenz right
there, Gen Gaming 2. I'm not too sure what the problem is. But we'll double check on that later. Let's just continue casting with this game right now. The Dire team is leading 27 kills to 5. But then again, kills don't mean anything if you haven't gotten the racks yet. Aggressive warding coming out here from Team Ow. Hello, Zenz.
Test it. Hello. I think that Radiant team might have a slightly chance to come back considering they lost two racks, and I can't think of a way how they're gonna come back from this game. What do you think?
It's definitely not going to be easy. If they come back in this game, it's going to be it has to be from a perfect team fight. The Witch Doctor has to land his ultimate for full duration once the weave has set into full effect. So really, it has to be a combination of things that are just going to be so hard for the Radiant to actually try to pull together.
Considering death
though. Oh, blink forward in silence from the park, but the quick telegrade perhaps too early. Snowball coming in onto Drugs here at the back end. They've already gotten the Dazzle out of the game, full duration. That's a good ultimate coming from the Witch Doctor. Good amount of damage, but the Mana Void will immediately stop it as the Anti-Mage gets a double kill, leaning on the Light Striking Ray, but it's too late. He's lost most of his teammates already, and there's a good stun from the Dragon Knight, but there's just so much damage over on the side of the Dire. Glimmer Cave already onto the Winter Wyvern, and we'll call Embrace up the Tusk to help heal him up. And the Anti-Mage is just really hitting top speed right now. He's got good farm. You don't expect to see Anti-Mages really hit until the 27 minute mark, but he's just gotten so much farm and it's just so far ahead of the Radiant team that he's really able to be a force to be reckoned with.
Well, considering that Witch Doctor has an death ward with a 60 damage per second Witch Ward with a single target, which I don't think is a very good damage dealt to the Dire team.
That's true. And we look at the Dire team, they're looking to take Roshan right now, playing really, really well with the illusions. So a quick tip for you guys out there, if you do not know, illusions can tank Roshan. Just pop them outside of the Rosslyn and just issue a move command and click onto Roshan, and he will aggro onto your Manta or your illusions. Who do you think the Aegis will go to, the Puck or the Anti-Mage?
The Anti-Mage indeed. I mean, Southeast Asia Gaming will prioritize their carry as their main priority. Is it gonna be a Puck or
it's gonna be the Puck? no worries, no worries. Should have made a bet with you on that one. And now the Dire team are looking to put pressure now onto the middle lane. And 60 and 3, I think it's going to be really hard for the Radiant team to come back. But stranger things have happened. Oh, you're right. Puck does have a Shiva's Guard. Thank you for pointing that out, as the Tusk does have his drums and four staff. And they are looking to pressure this mid tier 2 tower. Puck going for a Lincoln Spear right there.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Well, it seems like Puck don't want to get caught by the Usurper, considering he want to play safe, get protected.
Well, that's a very good point. And they're even stacking up the jungle, the Ancients on the Radiant side, and looking to farm up the Ancients by themselves. Anti-Mage, he's gotten his Heart of Tarrasque, 26 minutes. He doesn't even need the BKB Zens.
Well, they know that the Radiant team has been playing physically, that's why they pick up the Winter Wyvern. As long as there's a physical, anyone is aiming physically to any hero, Akid burn to the trick.
More like
Cold Embrace, I'm sorry.
Yep, Cold Embrace. Well, that's very, very true. Alright, moving back onto things. Yeah, sorry, go on.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Alright, even though Anti-Mage with Black King, we must know that Winter Wyvern using his Glimmer Cap will do the trick, protecting Anti-Mage safe.
That's true, and right now the Fisher does come in, Ice Charge locks him in, Puck blinks forward and gets good silence onto the Darkseer. Darkseer is unable to get his wall replica out, Mana is already spent, and Super Lunar Blade onto the Tusk gets him out, Echo Slam on the Black Hero, buyback from the Black Hero, but the Force Shield's dead on the radio, silence the triple kill from the Urshaker, buyback again from the Lina and so, but I think it's too late, Watch Me Whip has no more mana, and he's unable to get any Light Strike Array, it's probably too late to save him, as the Shadow Grace comes out from the buyback as well, from the Dazzle, and they are throwing everything at the Dire side except the kitchen sink. Oh no! It's a disaster! Oh my god! I really think there's no way back at all for the Radiant team. What do you think, Zenz?
I think this is a game.
I think this is
GG. Considering they're brought back, but they can't do anything to protect their top lanes.
Zenz, that was a gold change of 3,000. 3,000 gold exchange. We're gonna let's look at the drop. They're 35,000 in advantage of gold. They're gonna get their second Rex. And there's really no reason for them to go back right now. There's no damage inside the Radiant. There's 22 seconds until the Dragon Knight comes out. And Blink forward aggressively from the anti-mage. And the Puck will pick it up with the Silence as well. Now Watch Me Sip will also die to the Shiva. And the last hit coming from the Puck. There's a double kill. Five heroes down from the Radiant team. And now we just wait for Radiant to call GG.
I think this is the game. There's no chance.
GG comes out from the Dazzle. Finally, 28 minutes into the game, 40-8. Well played to both teams.
Oh,
I've never seen the new animation yet from Wakeborn. Oh, it's pretty nice.
Well, that's it for the first game. When does the next game start, Brendan?
As soon as this game has ended.
Alright.
I'll take a screenshot.
I think... I should really change my wallpaper. Is it possible to actually leave this?
Never mind. Oh, just two more players waiting to load in. And we can start the introductions. Oh, IU. Lee Ji Yun.
Hello, hello everyone. Welcome to the second game here at CGC 2015. We've got New World Gaming
Radiant
up
team
against back. Autumn Gaming. Joining me is my co-caster, Zenz. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hello,
Zenz. Hello, according to rumors, that New World Gaming has been.
How are you?
Just
how are
as
you?
A favorite to win this tournament. Yeah, I'm fine. And I first ban on Radiant Team.
Oh, the first ban is the Undying looking to again. That tombstone, very, very annoying in the early game. If you don't get rid of it fast, you'll quickly find your health and your movement speed just being decreased. Leshrac ban coming out here
Radiant
from New
Team
World
ban.
Gaming.
Well, this is like seems like our second game to see a Leshrac ban.
Is
a it? Very popular pick.
He's just so strong, isn't he? Diabolic Edict, Pulse Nova, Split Earth, and Lightning. All very, very strong AoE spells. And he can melt
Five
down buildings and Rexus really quickly as the Winter Wyvern
Dire
removed by
ban.
Aris Walker.
There's gonna be a new patch in this incoming November major tournament.
Since your mic is breaking up, it might be your connection. Hopefully you can check your LAN cable.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
The IO being
Radiant
removed
team
out
picked.
Here by May, not wanting to face against a possible global relocate. First pick, are we going to see Alina?
It's 25 seconds
We're
left.
Testing.
You sound much better right now, less spiky and not so choppy.
Alright, hurry up.
Now.
10 seconds remaining.
Looks like Aris Walker's taking his time with his first pick. 10 seconds remaining
into
his normal
remaining.
Pick time. They did request for first pick since they lost the coin toss and now
reserve
into reserve time. Quite surprised, really.
Would you expect him to at least have something in his mind?
Lion
first pick?
Dire team pick.
What are your thoughts on that, Zenz? Don't think Zenz is with us at the moment. I'm just going to continue casting. Well, Lion first pick makes it really, really interesting. He's a good support, but at the same time, he's quite, you would need to say, level dependent. He really, really wants his level 6
Wind
really
Ranger
fast before
service.
He's effective. And immediately May coming out with a
Radiant
counter picks off the Witch Doctor and the Wind Ranger. Two very strong ranged heroes. Very good in the mid game and can transition well into the late game provided that they have enough farm.
Right now, looks like Autumn is going to be picking their second hero.
I would have expected to see Lina, to be quite honest, instead of the Lion. But apparently Lion does have more disables in terms of the Hex and the Spiked Earth, whereas Alina is more of a burst damage with the LSA.
Gyrocopter
second pick.
Radiant
That's very, very brave,
down.
Taking their hard carry into the second pick.
Gyrocopter looking to go for that AoE damage with the flat cannon and the cooldown, looking to set things up for his teammates.
When you go to pubs, you usually see the cooldown being used to... to provide, you know, the damage or the last hit or something. But actually, it's a really
Five
useful AoE
remaining.
Slow. Let's just have a quick look through the tooltip right there. Look at that. Missile 1 slow is 30%. If you're caught again, second one is 60%. And it just really removes all of your move speed. And Autumn now removing Bloodseeker from the pool.
Earth Shaker. A response to
Radiant
New World Gaming's
ban.
The combination of Lion and Gyrocopter is going to be one that's really interesting to see. Really depends on. Oh, welcome back, Sense.
Alright, and I was doing some connection problem there. Sorry about that.
Don't worry, mate. We're all good here. Oh, sorry, is that to Australia?
Alright, what did I miss? What did I miss during the pick and bend?
What you missed was that Radiant team took Lion and Gyrocopter.
Siao. Seems Radiant team just pick up a Gyrocopter. 10 seconds.
And Newell Gaming corresponded with the Witch Doctor Windranger pick. I was mentioning that how the Windranger can actually scale as a really, really good last hitter, especially when she's got an acceptor to add to her focus fire.
Well, what do you think? On Newell Gaming gonna pick up any hero, any carry hero? What do you, Windranger gonna be a carry hero, offlane or mid? What do you think? Seems like Windranger is very versatile in a landing.
Ya, pada pendapat saya rasa perlu melihat kepada New World Gaming pick up hero yang ketiga. Jikalau New World Gaming memilih silencer.
Oh, it's
a silencer. We're going to see a silencer in this game. So, that's three intelligence heroes. I think that Windranger is going to go mid and silencer looks to be a support or a carry silencer. That's what I think is going to happen.
Well, it seems that New World Gaming has been having a very versatile laning hero here.
That's true.
It could be anything.
Well, you never know what to expect, but Clockwork comes up from Autumn, and we all know which lane Clockwork goes best, and that's the off lane.
Well, we also see S4 using Clockwork on the mid.
Oh, yeah.
He was also a very good.
He managed to get level 6. He managed to get hookshot at like minute 5. And the Omni Knight Sense. This is a really interesting pick coming out here from New World Gaming. So the Omni Knight, it's burst heal, as well as magic resistance through the repel, magic immunity rather, sorry, as well as the Guardian Angel providing physical damage immunity and Ogre Magi.
Puff and stuff.
Puff and stuff.
I hope she's not listening to this.
What
do you think in a very good next ban on the Radiant team?
I think the Radiant team.
Autumn is.
Oh, sorry. I think what Radiant
seems
team.
Like they are...
10 seconds. All right, I'll go first.
Okay, so I think that Radiant team is gonna take out Tusk, or either a strong offlaner or just a right click carry just to be safe. Anti-Mage still in the pool, Juggernaut still in the pool, Tiny not that useful without the IO, but in my opinion, they are looking to hopefully ban New World Gaming from getting a right clicker. I think the supports will be the Witch Doctor and Omni Knight. And there
it
you go.
It's gonna be a clink again.
Faceless Void. Brilliant team pick. So I think the Windranger is definitely going off lane now. Silencer will probably go mid.
Wow. They just easily pick up a Witch Doctor and a Void combo without banning Void.
They did. Zeus. And the Zeus comes out. We're going to see the Plumber Mario. Electric Mario. And I'm just gonna change the overlay really quickly. Now just waiting for the players to pick up the heroes. And well, Zenz, Bets, who do you think is going to win this one? Which lineup do you like better?
Well, I personally like a Wombo combo lineup, so I would like to choose a New World Gaming, but I would like to see a solo pickup on a hero too, so it's a half-half for me, because love to see our solo pickups too. What about you, Inferno?
Oh, for me, probably gonna go with my heart tells me that remaining. The Radiant team pick is really cool. I really like the idea that Clockwork, Zeus, and Gyro's remaining. There. So, on the other side, again, you know, Neural Gaming does have a very, very combo heavy lineup. Do you think you want to introduce the teams? I'll go off with the Dire team. Tsukiet's right, on
sure.
That Windranger. Gluttony is on that Witch Doctor. Mei on the Omni Knight. Faceless Void will be played by Milky, and looks like Zero Attitude will be playing that. What's that hero? What's that hero? What's the last hero's ends? On the Silencer. Silencer. why don't you go ahead and introduce the Raiden team?
Now we have Octum, SD, SD on the Zeus, IU on the Clockwork, Iris Walker, Lion, dot dot dot, and a Gyrocopter, and also blah blah, Bradship, and a Ojo Magi.
Well, we're just gonna wait for a few more seconds right now for Zero Hero. Finally does pick his hero. There you go, that's a Silencer picked up. Oh look, Zeus has got the Immortal. And if you remember from the compendium levels in the past TI5, it was Zeus that was guaranteed a character remodel, or was it an Immortal? Character remodel, right?
No, it's an Arcana challenge.
Arcana
challenge? He just won an Arcana challenge.
Oh, he did. Oh, it's just... It's just
It's blocking me.
Alright, resume. Oh, everyone's got Immortals right now. Gluttony with the Immortal Witch Doctor. Windranger. Oh no, she's got the floral set. And over on the Raiden team, Azd with the Immortal Zeus. Lion with the TI3 Immortal. Ogre Magi, no Immortals. Gyrocopter, no Immortals as well. That's a shame. And they're gonna contest the runes. What do you think about this, Sense? What do you think? Which team has the advantage over which rune?
Definitely the Radiant team, because they have more burst power damage. Considering Gyrocopter with the a very early rocket barrage, with at damage per second.
Oh, you bring up a
and
very
also
good
Zeus.
Oh, that's true. But Zeus immediately goes for the Arc Lightning as the first skill. It's gonna be a four. Against four heroes here over onto the top rune.
No.
Are they really going to challenge for it? Zeus, they're revealing the skills already. Silencer showing that he's taken Glaives of Wisdom. And they do not need to fear the silence anymore. They know it's just Glaives of Wisdom, it's not Last Word or Curse of the Silent. And they're just going to jockey around here in this top bounty rune position, which will probably most likely go to the Clockwork, I think.
The battle begins.
Yes, it does go to Clockwork.
Yep, it's gonna be on it.
On the bottom bounty rune, Tsukiyat picks it up unchallenged on the Wind Ranger. He's gonna play offlane, and his item build, it's actually a very versatile one, has no commitment yet towards the Basilisk. Instead, will possibly be going for the early Null Talisman.
Well.
And the Radiant team are making their way onto the tri lane. At the bottom lane, that's going to be Gyrocopter, protected by the Ogre Magi, as well as the Lion, who's being spotted out by that ward over there. And Silencer doing pretty well early on, getting three last hits.
Yep. Cool.
Oh, how do you lane against this, Zenz? It's so annoying. So annoying.
Silencer is very quite smart for learning the cost of silencing, so that SD is used start learning of lightning, so he would take a second and skill, which is the Glaive of Wisdom and also Last Word.
That's very very true. So, looking over the top lane, the Clockwork, are you having some fun? He's now level 2 as opposed to the Dire off lane, also level 2, but the Windranger has got the creep wave right under her tower and can last hit quite safely.
Are you a cameraman?
No, I did not designate myself as cameraman.
Alright, cool.
Anyway, from what the spectators on the YouTube live YouTube stream will be seeing, it will be from my feed, so it's fine either way.
Alright, cool.
10 last hits on the Faceless Void, 11 make it with 4 denies, being unchallenged so far right now. He's doing really, really well controlling the creep wave right where he wants it.
Just what the doctor ordered.
And Zero Attitude, who is put up with the hashtag House Stark, Spoiler alert. About master. Oh, are you challenging main? May going for the purification, but doesn't really get much of the damage over onto the clockwork. Onto the mid lane. Oh, that's gonna be a tight battle over in the mid lane. Will he continue chasing? Does get Curse of the Silent and the Impale, or rather Split. Is that the Impale or Split Earth? I think it's Impale, right? Earth Spike. Oh, Jesus Christ. Then the Earth Spike, actually, is missed by the Lion. So, very fortunate there from Silencer, getting out of that one alive. Does harass the Zeus down quite a bit. And unfortunately, both heroes are out of mana, so Zeus will be heading back to the base, back to the fountain, and Lion will try to pick up the levels here in the mid lane that's been vacated by the Thunder God.
Considering that taking the 3 spot of the last hit slash denies, while Windrunner has been taking the 3rd spot, winning the set lane Gyrocopter.
That's true, the Wind Ranger actually is outlast hitting
the carry safe lane, which has got 2 supports, or rather 1 support, babysitting.
And also, seems like Claw Ayu is not doing a very good job on the off lane, on the top.
No, that's true, but then when you think about it again, Ayu is a melee hero, so he really has to get up close to the creeps if he wants to get those last hits. Level 3, almost level 4. Level 5 already on Sukiyat, like you mentioned earlier.
And
oh, red and team.
Double damage. Controlling the runes again. Did they block their own camp? Oh no, they wasted a sentry. That sentry.
Yep.
Oh, they wasted something. Does that block the camp?
Yeah, the observer ward would block the camp.
Oh, the observer ward blocks. Oh, that's right, the observer ward blocks the camp. Well, they're gonna be frustrated with that. That's 100 gold. I missed the first blood.
Double damage there from the witch doctor. So I think that's, there was a Maledict? No Maledict. They just right clicked him. Purified.
That was a really, really weird kill. I didn't expect to see that at all. I mean, considering that the top heroes, Omni and Faceless Void, they're both melee heroes, and the Clockwork can just quickly cog if he feels like he's in danger, but apparently that didn't happen. Windranger already with phase roots, and right now Zeus getting harassed really, really badly by the Silencer. Looks like it's going to be a kill for the Silencer right now. Oh, the one charge just saves him just in time. And he will survive with about 80 HP and drops his mantle to try to get the most out of those battle charges. Really well done there. Oh, Windranger in a bit of trouble herself. But will escape with that wind run. Looking over at the last hits and denies, 38 last hits on the Faceless Void, 15 denies. The Silencer up next with 27, so he's controlling that mid lane really, really well. Silencer's already level 6. Miss, this will be the first. I'm not sure what you're trying to say there. Anyway, moving back towards the lanes. Zeus quite slow without his boots yet. 6 minutes and still has not taken his boots. If he gets chased down by the Silencer, he'll be in huge trouble. He's only got 295 MS compared to 345. This will be the first blood miss on CDG. Ultimate does come out and they're looking to get a clockwork right there over the top lane. Maledic does come out. Cogs will push the Faceless Void back on Earth Spike as well as the Hex onto Milky, but the purification will heal him back. TP coming in from Gyrocopter will look to ulti. That's a very, very good ultimate onto. Will get his Rocket Barrage on, but Faceless Void will time walk up towards the top lane, towards the top tier 1 tower, and they will disengage. That's an Omni Knight brought down in exchange for the global silence and a TP from the Gyrocopter. So all in all, that was all right. They managed to save the Clockwork from going down, but they did manage to get a kill on the Omni Knight in exchange for that TP. So
all in all, pretty good right now as things stand for the Radiant. Hello, Sense, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Right? Considering that Oracle Mage, I didn't manage to TP's because he was insufficient funds on buying TP's, so he was just staying on the bottom lane, couldn't help top lane.
The Ogre Magi has an orb of venom sense.
Oh. Well, big, I'm trying to be a very versatility hero, gank as much possible, doing some, how many percent? 12% slow seems like a very big difference.
Exactly, and don't forget that the Ignite also gives 22% slow, and also the Gyrocopter gives a 30% slow with his first missile and 60% slow. So really, if they're able to actually stack those slows quite well, they'll be able to catch any hero, even the Whip Ranger.
Oh, the pink Omni Knight.
Well, they saw him pick up the Haste Rune with that ward.
For justice!
Got a smoke over on the lion, but don't think that they're ready for a smoke gank just yet. Possibly waiting for the lion to hit level 6. He's only level 3 right now. But Wind Ranger, level 8. He's almost the same level as his mid lane hero.
And Zeus finally will pick up his boots. Yep, Zenz. Witch Doctor again picks off the clockwork. And that's just a really weird kill. I mean, I'm not too sure about that. So most of the damage did come from the face of force. So possibly a... Nah, I'm not sure if he actually hit a time block. Don't think so. But the clockwork is being really, really harassed badly. Is very underleveled. Doesn't have his level 6 just yet. And is unable to contribute much in terms of ganks or even team fights.
And also Silencer just pick up for me Radiant's
top tower has fallen. Oh, Hand of Midas level 9 with wand and boots. It's really, really not top bad at all. Oh, ultimate coming up from the Faceless Void and will kill off the lion. And Autumn right now with a rocket barrage looking to try to get Milky. Purification is ready and there it goes. A shackle shot misses. But the fight will happen right now. Call down coming on from the gyrocopter. Gluttony is just out of reach with the right clicks and will TP out in front of the face, but finally the Witch Doctor does fall to the Gyrocopter. TP of three heroes coming up top with the Zeus as well joining and the Orga Magi. So really this party of heroes, is it worth it to get a Witch Doctor? You just lost one hero, but you had to TP another hero.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Well, it seems like Silencer is having a very great farm on the middle lane and then has been ignored by none of the Radiant team.
No, that's true. Looking to build into their power treads, already has a Glove of Haste in his stash. They're picking out the bottom tier 1 tower to defend, but really there's no one there, so Gyrocopter is just going to make his way over there.
Does have the Ring of Aquila, looking to go into the drums, does have the bracers already. Net worth, look at that. Faceless Void, 5.4k. He's leading the Silencer by
Radiant's
a fair bit of margin.
Is under attack.
He's already got his Mask of Madness.
KDA. Oh, that's correct. 75 last hits as well. He does have his Mask of Madness, got his Aquila as well. And we'll be looking to pressure this top lane a little bit as a smoke gank from the Raiden team comes up. Five heroes converging here on the bottom, but look at that awareness being shown by the Wind Ranger. Wind Ranger?
Radiant's
Runner? Wind Runner? Wind Ranger?
Both the same.
It's both the same, that's right. Look at that awareness being shown there by Tsukiat, really. He knows that all heroes are missing and he just doesn't even go beyond his tower. It's just tower hugging and farming with his power shot. Right now, Zeus coming over to the middle lane trying to get something done, but no avail. They're just wasting time.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Seems like the guys to the new good farm seems to be. I mean, look at the first tree. It's still Void, Alancer, Windrunner. Wow, the safe lane Gyrocopter. Not to say it's not going doing a good job, but he's flaking off some farms here.
Oh, look at the top lane. Chronosphere does come on, and the Global Silence as well. Zeus can't help with anything. The Global Silence is still there. Lion will come up with Earth Spike, but the ultimate coming from Witch Doctor is immediately interrupted by the Zeus and his Thunderbolt. And the Zeus ultimate does go off. Rocket Barrage will actually kill off the Faceless Void and the Witch Doctor will fall to the Zeus. That's a really, really good trap there set by the Radiant team. Oh my god.
The armor.
The ultimate of the Zeus. Sorry?
It wouldn't be a disaster if Witch Doctor cast a Melodic, but he missed the Melodic in the Chronosphere.
Oh, that's really true. That's really true. Quick thinking by the Zeus was to interrupt the Witch Doctor ultimate with his thunder, with his lightning bolt. Sorry. And the Thunder God's Wrath also doing so much damage now that he's got 2 points into the static field, which just hurts you the more HP that you have. Well, looks like they're gonna catch two heroes right now in the bottom lane. No. No fear, they're shown by the gyrocopter. He's just gonna keep farming.
They spotted up the Witch Doctor.
They spotted the Witch Doctor as well. Call down does come out. The first missile will hit, and as for the second one, the drums were popped, but it's already dead there. Witch Doctor dying to the rocket barrage, and Maledict will not pop him, not enough damage. Oh, no, he'll be fine. Be just fine. Does get the stun over onto Tsukiat, but Okimajai will retreat as well. Looks like the Wind Ranger is gonna go for a 4-staff. Already has a 4-staff, sorry about that. And just spent it. I wonder what his item will be like in the next 10 minutes. So do you think he'll be going for the Ag Scepter? Or will he go for the Mechanism?
Who? You?
Wind Ranger.
Oh, Wind Ranger. I would say it would be Aghanim Scepter, maybe. I mean, following by the meta, everyone has been prioritized Aghanim Scepter.
Global Silence coming out. What's happening? Over into the top lane, which... Oh no, it's actually a pickoff of the Lion. They actually were willing to blow off a Global Silence for that. So how long is it down for again? It's down for 120 seconds now. And over onto the middle lane, Shackle Shot will lash the Ogre Magi to the trees, and there will be no pursuit as the Dire team will disengage. No more mana on the Omni Knight, so they might be looking to recharge their batteries a little bit. Over into the top lane, Time Warp, Chronosphere as well being blown for IU, and Milky will get the pick really, really easily. That's another kill in the pocket right there for Milky. And Iris Walker, will he move forward? Nope. He will not choose. He's not even level 6 yet. It's minute 15 and Lion does not have his ultimate. And again, neither... Oh, Omni Knight. Omni Knight doesn't go for this ulti. He's got 3 in Purification and 3 in Repel. What do you think about that, Sense?
Well, because if you look at the Radiant side, they are very physically hero, so... They know that Gyrocopter...
Oh, double hero tackle there from the Wind Ranger onto the bottom lane. Wrath of God does come out, but the ultimate by Gluttony will kill off the Ogre Magi. Now they're in chase against the Gyrocopter. Mask of Madness being popped, Smoke being popped for the extra movement. See, will there be another tackle? Yes, there will be, but it will not let time. What will move forward and try to get it to slow down? There's a final kill coming up there from the Faceless One, and Purification will save the Silencer from going down. I'm so sorry to interrupt you there, Zenz, but they got a double hero shackle there on the bottom lane, Ogre Magi and Gyrocopter, yeah. And they both paid the price heavily.
Well, I actually missed the double shackle shot. Seems like it's a very good shackle. Taking it out, Gyrocopter, and who? Ogre Magi.
Yeah, Light of Heaven shackle, oppa!
Stepping up the invisibility room.
And there's no ward from the Radiant team other than the one that's overlooking the top rune. The jungle.
And Faceless Void just pick up and Demon Dash. A rush. Daedalus maybe?
Possibly Daedalus?
Or maybe a Monkey Kimba.
Well, the thing is, the Gyrocopter is very, very, very far away from his Butterfly, so I don't think there's any fear that he's gonna actually go towards that Butterfly just yet. Possibly a Demon Edge, I do agree with you, a good source of damage. There's no real need for him to actually get the MKB just yet. And oh, as the Repel Global Silence does come out, ASD is being hit so much damage there from Milky. And even though he has his Mask of Madness on, an ultimate coming out from Global Silence, double shackle again, heading on the line as well as Ogre Magi. RU will be caught by the final bounce of the Paralyzing Cast, and Faces Point is forced forward, and the Chronosphere will be popped. That's 4 heroes down the side of the Radiant. One thing that I forgot to mention was that Milky popped his Mask of Madness, and usually when you pop your Mask of Madness, you receive amplified damage, but then the repel coming up from the Omni Knight just prevents the damage from actually being effective. And that's a really good combo, actually. Mask of Madness with repel. It's almost like your Juggernaut with MOM. Radiant structures
are fortified. Exactly. We usually see a competitive Dota mesh. You will see that Void usually pick up some BKB, but in this mesh, no. They know that Void, Omni Knight staying back, repelling.
Oh, stun coming up there onto Milky. They will force up in Uncle. Wrath of God comes out, but there will be a quick kill there onto the line. Fox come out, swing the fight onto three. Call down comes out and will hit two heroes over there. Husky is solo right now. They finally get the kill onto the Omni Knight. And also the Witch Doctor's Silence. Curse on the Silence coming out from the Silencer. He's got no mana as he's chased down by the Rocket Barrage. And looks like the Gyrocopter will get the kill onto the Silencer as the Faceless Void is just chasing everyone down. Time walk onto the Ogre Major. Does get the kill. Triple kill for the Faceless Void. And right now, Autumn. Dot dot dot. It's just being shackled to the tree now. Zero Attitude can cast a Kiss of Silence on him and steal the intelligence. And there you go. It's a team wipe.
On the side of the Radiant, five heroes lost and they've only gotten two supports.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Sense, what's happening? Every game we're seeing, it's just like the Radiant team's just crumbling with the team fights.
Turn back the clock.
Well, looks like it is, and MKB coming out there from Milky. He's got two javelins over in his stash ready to be picked up. And we'll be looking to progress into this next item. So that nullifies the threat of the Gyrocopter going for the butterfly or any evasion items right now. There's just no room to farm right now. Net worth. Looking at the XP graph, it's more than 10,000 in the favor of the Dire. Looking at the gold graph, it's more than almost 14,000 in favor of the Dire. 7 to 16 is the kill difference. But really, there is so little that the Raiden can do. They can't even farm their own jungle safely without being without the threat of a kill from the, oh, jump forward, time warp onto the Omni Knight. I beg your pardon. Onto the Ogre Magi. The Wind Ranger will secure the kill with the power shot as they pressure the bottom tier 2 tower. The Raiden team really should just give this tower up. There's no reason to defend it. It's four heroes against four, but at the same time, you've got your Silencer who's just going to split push the top lane. Has already completed a four staff as well as power treads. Possibly looking for a Atos. That's usually a good item on the Silencer, but as things stand, we're not sure ourselves. That's one tower down over on the tier two. Finally, Raiden will have all five heroes up. And damage here being taken by the top tier 2 tower. TP coming in from the Ogre Magi. Will look to farm things up. And they're going now for a quick Roshan. But the damage from Milky is just so incredible. 118 plus 97, so more than 205 over for each and every right click. And double that every time he gets a time lock in. Oh, 70 bonus damage. Sorry, every time he gets a time lock in the Chronosphere, it's doubled. Smoke coming out from the Dire team. Trying to pursue. They have an Observer Ward right now, spotting rotations into the safe lane jungle, but really they're not gonna do much. OM will dispel the smoke. Yes, he will. They spot him. Paralyzing cast does come on to Blah Blah Sheep. Suket will be there. Looks to shackle him. What a long range shackle! But I don't think that they'll get the kill. Melody. Oh, they're actually committing to it. Ultimate comes out from Gluttony, and that will be the kill secured on the side of the Dire. They just abandoned the OM right there to his fate, not even deciding to reinforce that fight in any little bit of way. They just tried to get back as soon as they can and left the Ogre Magi for dead. Knocking on the doors of the throne right now is the Dire team at the tier 3 tower. It will come down. Looks like they're looking to get Rax as well, focusing on the melee Rax, and there really shouldn't be any reason that they shouldn't get it. The Raiden team is not able to fight this right now as the repel comes up from the Omni Knight onto the Faceless Void, who will just focus the hits on the creep as well as the Rax. The damage from the Glaives are with him as well. Chronosphere onto two right now. The Death is used down. Call down as well from the Gyrocopter. Fireback immediately from the Zeus. We'll look to go for the Thunder God's Wrath. So much damage right there. The slowdown's coming as well. But the Guardian Angel will prevent any more heroes. Four heroes already down. The Aegis will trigger for the Faceless Void. But that is four heroes down. And he's all alone right now. And he really should be going down. The drum charges being popped right now. But Milky
is more than happy to run forward. Pops his Mask of Madness. A TP coming in from this new trend. So down Rocket Barrage. Oh, the damage is so much because of the Mask of Madness being popped. Time walks away and slows down everyone else instead. And they're still trying to chase to this and hopefully try to get a kill right now. But they're going the wrong way. And they just got the lightning bolt just in the wrong place. And my goodness, Zenz, are you back?
Yeah, but there were some issues on the gaming one. I mean,
well, you just Dyer's missed the Radiant winning their first team fight.
Yeah, there was just a 3-minute break, and boom, Midtower was gone.
Midtower was gone, but the Radiant actually won the team fight. I think it was worth it. They managed to kill off 5 heroes, but technically 4 because of the Aegis. But they managed to kill off every single hero in that team fight and actually survive. It did cause them to come back. That's a Shackler shot coming out the Gyrocopter. And whatever I said just now, forget it. Gyrocopter dying in the top lane right now, and the tower being denied as well. Oh dear. Well, he was too aggressive. He should have noticed that the new world heroes were already spawning, and it looks like they're going to just push over onto the top lane.
Oh, let's fight just pick up Monkey King Bar.
He picked up that Monkey King Bar about 5 minutes ago. He's actually gone for the Crystallis. So Daedalus most of the next time. The time walks forward onto IU. And now you see him, now you don't. And that's definitely Rax confirmed there. There's just no way that the Raiden can defend this with his 3 heroes. But Daedalus gonna play it safe instead. He's gonna try to pressure the top tier 2 tower.
Radiant's top tower. Just they're going for the range. Melee rank. Radiant's
top tower. Oh, that's
not
right.
For a very aggressive. Radiant structures
are fortified. Fortification coming in, but the melee racks in the mid lane will go down and they'll retreat out of this fight. Play it safe, play it cool. Perhaps wait for the next Rashan before they make a decision. But nope, Rappel comes in. Faces one looking to jump in, looking to Chrono. One hero will jump in and time walk onto the Zeus. Thunder God's Rush does come out, but there's nothing to do. Finally, the Corn Spear does come up. It's only on one, that's on Ogimaja. And immediately, the ultimate of the Witch Doctor is interrupted by the line. Good Earth Spike right there, but that's 3 heroes from the Radiant team down. Godlike on the Faceless Void. Radiant's middle
barracks has fallen. Forget the Death Ward. Rax means everything.
Forget the Death Ward. Rax means everything. And they actually can pressure the top lane. I hate to say this, but GG. Dire's bottom
tower was under attack. Yep. Death Ward was being cancelled by Earth Spike Light.
Wind Ranger with the Aghanim Scepter already completed as well. Does have Focus Fire still onto the tower. So, call down first. Rocket will hit. Second rocket will not hit anything. And they're just gonna focus on the range melee. Oh, sorry, on the range barracks up on the top lane, which won't regen. Oh, 4-star forward from the Ogre Magi will catch the Silencer as well as the hook shot onto Global Silence coming up from the Silencer. They're trying to split the fight up. Faceless Void this time walks in against the Lion, kills him off with impunity. Focus Fire doing so much damage right there onto the Ogre Magi as Lion falls in the backline. Zeus as well will die. That's it. I think there's just no way that the Radiant team can come back from this deficit. That GG well played, called out there.
Radiant's top barracks. It was a great play by the Radiant team, just that there was a slightly misplayed by...
Alright Zenz, tell us when the next match will start.
Next match will start as Cutting Gaming 1 finishes game.
Alright, you just heard that, ladies and gentlemen. So if you want to tune in onto Curtain Gaming 1, feel free to do so over in the... Just add his Dota ID, and you'll be able to spectate his games with ease. So that's it from us for this game. We'll see you at the next game. Bye, Zenz.
Bye.
Thank you.
Welcome everybody.
Radiant third game team back.
It's Team RR against Team GDS. And Icy is the captain for GDS, and we'll be doing the pick and bans with Pain on Team RR. Doing the picks and bans. First ban coming out is the Bristleback, and it's Radiant countered immediately with a Undying ban by the Dire team. So that leaves Lesharak still in the pool, Storm Spirit as well. Two heroes that have been frequently picked in meta games, and the Silencer ban does come out.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Now this is our third game seeing Undying getting banned, banned, and banned again.
No, that's right.
Radiant team pick. Dire team pick.
Sorry, so the first pick over from the Raiden team is the Gyrocopter. Again, a reminder, Lesharak and Storm Spirit both still in the pool.
Also, Lina is still on the pool.
That's very, very true indeed. And the Tusk coming out here from Team RR, hoping to play it in Zai's fashion over at TI5. He made it a very, very successful hero.
10 seconds remaining.
Well, are we gonna see a techies from Ranger Ranger? I really hope so.
That's true. Also, you might see a techies. But as things stand at the moment, reserve time coming in on to the Dire team. I haven't really chosen a hero yet. Bloodseeker also out of the pool. They go with the Shadow Fiend.
Wow, this is our first game looking at Shadow Fiend.
Well, that's absolutely correct.
So, what's gonna go to sleep gonna respond to Dietic's pick?
Well, the thing about...
Is he gonna be an...
Sorry?
10 seconds.
Yeah, yeah, sorry about it.
Oh, I was gonna say that the Tusk remaining. Pickup actually grants you invulnerability while you're in the snowball, so it's a good way to save your reserve teammates time. As well. It's not just an initiation skill, but you can also use it to save the Shadow Fiend, for example, if the cooldown is coming down.
Also, you get to choose which teammates you want to save. With right click on a hero, you get to pick anyone into a snowball. And we're gonna see a witch.
Witch Doctor does indeed come out here from Team GDS AC, picking it up to follow up with
remaining.
The Gyrocopter. As things go right now, it's a very physical damage lineup from both teams, Dire and the Radiant Swell.
Reserve time.
Third ban now coming in from GTS. Again, to remind, Lina, Lesharak, Storm Spirit, all still in the pool, but for some reason, they are not going for those picks. They're instead preferring the Tusk and Shadow Fiend, as well as Gyrocopter and Witch Doctor. Anti-Mage ban.
Dire team ban.
So, GTS removing the Anti-Mage from the pool. I think the stand in... Oh no, that was a different team. My apologies. So removing the Anti-Mage from the pool, that removes the right-click potential from the Dire team, but still so many carries in the pool. One reason that you might want to remove the Anti-Mage as well is once the Witch Doctor does cast his ultimate, that's a huge portion of his mana pool gone. And usually you'll see the Witch Doctor casting his combo with the Paralyzing Cast, the Maledict, and then finally follow up with the ultimate, so... Really... quite a potential threat. It can also interrupt
any of the TPs as well as the channeling skills. Templar Assassin Ban coming out here from the Dire, removing that potential face up against mid that the Shadow Fiend might see. Lanaya is a very interesting hero in the sense that if she's able to snowball, she'll be unstoppable all the way through the late game. She needs a really, really good start, however, and if she falls behind, it's really, really difficult for the Templar Assassin to catch up to the farm of other heroes. Spirit Breaker ban from Team GTS, not wanting that global initiation range with a charge of darkness or the very, very useful ultimate of the Spirit Breaker.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
And just changing a few settings over in the stream. This time we're only dropping 8% of the frames, unlike as it was in CSGO, where we were dropping 30% of the frames, quite unfortunately.
Dire team pick.
Alright, moving on with the picks. Storm Spirit finally out of the pool. And Wind Ranger pickup, that's definitely going to go into the off lane for Team RR. Team GDS now on their third pick. What will they go for? Taking their time there, AC not showing his hands immediately.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Winter Wyvern.
A Winter Wyvern pick up there coming up from AC. We've seen this hero in every other game, every alternating game. Very useful utility hero, able to just use the Cold Embrace, which encases an ally in an icy cocoon, freezing them solid while healing a base amount as well as a percentage of the maximum health each second. The most important part is that this cocoon actually blocks all physical damage. So that means only magical damage, which is in the form of razors, and the power shot will go through. Also, the Winter's Curse, a well-placed Winter's Curse, is actually able to disrupt the fight so much, especially when you consider that Shadow Fiend is such a heavy right-clicker. Now, Juggernaut response coming out here from Pain, picking up the Unero, as it was called in Dota 1. Going for quite heavy right click. So again, these are picks that the Winter Wyvern counters quite comfortably, but it really depends to be seen if the Gyrocopter is actually able to kite the Juggernaut around.
10 seconds remaining.
Team GDS to pick the mid hero, Invoker Leshrac. Nope, they're gonna hold their cards very close to the chest. Gonna pick the Darkseer for their offlaner. Your mic's getting cut off every now and then.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
And the Team RR will now move into their reserve time and will ban out the Queen of Pain.
Radiant team ban.
I think that the GTS team will choose to ban out another support. Oh, there's good. That's the Earthshaker ban.
Dire
very, very good hero, but we saw it being played in the offlane in the first game at around 7 o'clock. Sorry, your microphone's very, very choppy. It's on and off. I can't really hear your sentence as well.
10 seconds remaining.
It's like you're lagging out.
5 seconds remaining.
Alright, moving on. Zeus. Oh, that makes it really interesting.
Radiant
so,
pick.
I'm confused.
Zeus mid, Juggernaut off lane, Shadowfiend's got to go mid. I'm really interested to see how they line this up.
Is it clear?
Your mic is still really, really bad. I'm not able to hear your sentences completely. It's cutting off half sentence all the time. So, going back about this lanes onto the Dire team, we'll probably see the Tusk as a support. Shadowfiend definitely will be better off either mid or safe lane. Juggernaut, Zeus as well, probably means it's going to be a Zeus support, I think. It'll be very interesting to actually see how they're going to line this up. Eventually. Having a little look at items right now. Gyrocopter, what cosmetics has he got? Nothing. Witch Doctor. Oh, does have the taunt. Oh, Darkseer seems to have the most complete set,
having the totems of Imperial Relics. And
does have the Imperial Relics
set. Winter Wyvern, no items yet. Dragon Knight. The Enchanted Plate of the Crimson Wyvern. But instead is using an inscribed ash tongue with the Knight's Repose as a kinetic gem. Very, very interesting. Over on the Radiant. That was a Radiant team. Over the Dire side. Shadowfiend does have the inscribed Arms of Desolation as well as the inscribed Demon Eater. probably very, very confident in his Shadowfiend. So it remains to be seen.
Finally gonna see them how they're gonna lane. Yeah, it's gonna be a Windranger support, I think. As she does buy out the courier. And they make a beeline straight away. A TP by the Winter Wyvern. Willing to waste up to, what is that, 100 gold. Just so he can plant the ward early. And they're pinging out the Rosh bit. Probably gonna hide in there. Does it spot? Yes, it does. It does spot out that they're hiding in the Rosh pit. And now AC should be really, really careful before grabbing that bounty rune. They're pinging into Rosh pit as well. And Juggernaut being very, very brave.
Does have the uphill vision and knows there's no hero right there right now.
And finally, four heroes will show themselves at the bottom rune.
As over in the top rune, AC will be snatching that bounty rune. So both mid heroes will be getting the bounty runes and
be even closer to their bottles.
Probably going to look at a bottle timing of 2.5 minutes for both heroes. Oh, what is this? Looks like the Dire team are going to have a quick trip round over to the bottom safe lane pool. They are looking to intercept the creeps. Yes, no, maybe. Four heroes here right now. Pings coming out there by Zeus. Oh, they'll be revealed by the ward. So they definitely know they're somewhere there. And they're just going to hug the towers right now. Just waste the time of four heroes right here at the bottom lane. Someone's going to make the all the way to the top. I think that's a Juggernaut. Yep, there you go. He's starting to give his journey all to the top lane as it's going to be a tri-lane bottom of a Zeus, Windranger, and Tusk.
Very, very interesting combination right now coming out here in the aggressive try.
And looking at the last hits,
5-0 for the Shadow Fiend. While the Dragon Knight does have only 1, 2, 3.
Utterly denied.
Over at the bottom lane, it's transitioned more or less into a dual lane as the Tusk will come up to the top lane to support the Juggernaut. As a paralyzing cast does come out, Snowball will push the Tusk even further and push him into danger, but he will pull along the Juggernaut as well together. Juggernaut with a Blade Fury coming out, Koroke falling down really, really low. Can he follow up with the damage? Aishar just blocks him off, he blocks his own teammate off. And now Exodia with the Iron Shell harassing Watch Me Sip all the way down, but Pain has to TP to the top lane and try to defend his own support.
That Ice Shard was a bit weird. It blocked off his own teammate, the Juggernaut, from chasing all the way down with his Blade Fury. And now it's going to be a slightly more standard lane, a tri-lane top with the Tusk as well as the Zeus over in the top lane. And the bottom lane is a solo Windranger. It looks like Zeus just disconnected from the game for a while. So this is going to be a quick 3-minute pause, I think, as per the regulations. Mid lane, the Dragon Knight's doing all right. 4 hits to 1 denied, but against 8-3 of the Shadow Fiend, does have 11 souls, granting him an additional 22 bonus damage. Looking over to the wards, there's one Radiant Ward here blocking the pull camp, and one more just protecting their own jungle for any rotations. The Dire does have one ward overlooking the bottom rune. And that's about it, I think. There's no other wards that's coming out from the Dire team.
Moving on with the game.
I'm very sorry if I sound a bit tired. I've been casting since 11 o'clock in the morning. I should make this my career, actually. And picking out on the wards quite carefully. And I think they're telling Zeus to actually try and go do ward then. Of course, one important thing to note, Lightning Bolt will reveal True Sight in a 750 radius. So very useful for dewarding. So let's just... Oh, well, that's pretty weird. I'm seeing the... I'm seeing the effects of Shadow Fiend over here. So, no, just going over some theory crafting. let's just... shift the time forward to around about 12 minutes. By then, the mid lanes should have the bottle treads as well as a utility item available for use. A smoke gang should have been used. I think that in early level fights, the Radiant team will actually be able to... Pardon me. The Radiant team will actually be able to... Oh, Darkseer is disconnected as well. What am I saying? Radiant team will be able to win early game fights, mostly due to Paralyzing Cast as well as Melodic being some amazing early game spell. Not forgetting the Arctic Burn, which adds 200 range and goes for a 25% movement slow. Not forgetting the Splinter Blast as well, which does a good amount of damage if taken early on. Over the Dire team, if we're looking at an early game, we probably have Blade Fury, Power Shot, Razors... the Lightning Bolt maybe, because it's a support Zeus. So not really sure as to how much he's able to input by then. Tusk has rushed his bottle. Very interesting, he's sort of going for the boot. So it looks like they're going to camp around the top and bottom runes as well, just to prevent the Radiant team from getting those runes. Looks like both teams are ready, and we are going to resume the game. As Payne and Tusk will make their way back. He has spotted, however. But he doesn't have the mana to continue dewarding. So he's just gonna consume a mango right there and just keep up with the deward. That's a good 50 gold Dyer's into his pocket. Under attack. Bouncy rune going towards AC. Doesn't have the bottle just yet, but now finally does with that bouncy rune. And as you can see, it's 2.5 minutes for his bottle, whereas the Shadow Fiend should be in the courier, actually. Belongs to the Shadow Fiend. So both mid laners getting their bottles before the minute 3, as we predicted. And they're probably really working onto their treads or boots right now. Smoke does come in from the Dire team, and it's going to be very interesting to see how they're going to approach this team fight right now. Exodia is out in the open. Iron Shell up onto the creep, but he will spot it. Snowball will come in onto Darkseer and will pull along the Zeus as well. Exodia will be trapped by the Ice Shard, but it's Kuroki instead, and that will be the first blood there with the Blade Fury getting the last hit onto the Witch Doctor. Well executed. Not entirely sure if the smoke was necessary because they just dewarded the ward at the top rune. So, but all in all, a kill's a kill, and first blood's first blood. So, 1-0 right now in terms of death. Last hits, Shadow Fiend's doing really well, 20 to 10 last hits and denied, followed by the Darkseer, who's next with 11 last hits, most of them coming from the Iron Shell. Juggernaut falling close behind with 10 last hits with the Dragonite as well, but Bounce, I beg your pardon. Gyrocopter, surprisingly, only has 5 last hits. It's not doing a good job, really, as the carry right now. He needs to actually have his farm very, very early. He needs the Aquila and Boots to just have the survivability to stay in lane and have the mana to actually spam the Rocket Barrage. But as things stand, he's pretty far behind for a safe lane carry, and that's not looking too good right now for Team GTS.
Middle is missing.
Haste rune being picked up here from the Shadow Fiend as a kill happens over on the top lane. Darkseer just dying to the Juggernaut. He just chases him down with Blade Fury, and there you go. Arctic Burn will come out from GTS. Like, seriously, he will chase him and will converge over to with the Dragonite, but it's a bit too far to hit with the Dragon Tail as he doesn't have his level 6 just yet. That's a very long cooldown there from Arctic Burn. That's about 40 seconds he's got to wait before the spell is up online again. I was mentioning earlier concerning the Shadow Fiend. It's got a haste rune, so it definitely has kill potential against the Dragon Knight. And should be able to actually harass him even more and play a bit more riskier. But nothing will be coming out of that. Over in the top lane, Juggernaut just playing a little bit safe. Sees that there's two heroes right now over in the top lane for the Radiant, so he doesn't have any support nearby him. We'll just complete his face boots. Well, the Gyrocopter just got his brown boots. The Dire team doing really, really well here in the early game, transitioning to the early mid game. Gyrocopter really, really needs to be able to farm more than this. Finally starting to find those last hits a bit more. Has 9 missing those last hits. He's missing considerably easy last hits. Possibly because he feels he's under pressure. But no real reason to actually be that afraid. Shadow Fiend does have a haste rune, but there is a ward that is spotting out that rotation. So they're going to play really, really careful and try to hug the tower as much as they can. You reported and watch me sip. We'll just keep farming over in the lane, leaving on the top lane the Zeus as well as the Juggernaut. Just looking to try to get some last hits as much as possible, and hitting the Iron Shell actually dissipates a bit faster. Pulls happening over onto the safe lane. Just try to pull the creep wave a little further back. Now Young has a little bit more space to farm under his power. Does get hit by a shackle, but nothing much will happen. Missing even more last hits right now. Has only 10. It's over onto mid lane. Ice Shards does go out onto Dragon Knight. Dragon Tail coming up, as well as Paralyzing Cast and the Maledict onto Watch Me Whip. AC should be able to get the kill right now with the Maledict as well as the poison from the Dragon Knight. And they will look to chase Tusk, but Tusk will actually retreat under his tower for safety.
Over onto the top lane, Pain has been pulling the creeps as well, looking to try to get his level. Does have level 4 up and ready. Looking at the hero levels, the Shadow Fiend and the Dragonite, of course, ahead, being both mid lane heroes at level 6. The off laner is also doing well, level 6 each. Gyrocopter is half a level ahead of the Juggernaut, and the supports both level 4. Nothing much that they can do. And now that the Dragonite has pushed out that lane, watch me whip on the Shadow Fiend, is able to just collect his souls up a little bit again and get the count up back to the maximum 29. Over on the bottom lane, Windrun being hit onto the Gyrocopter will look to get a shackle. Long range power shot, no, misses entirely. So Gyrocopter, who has support of two heroes right now, is being harassed out of the lane by a solo Windrunner. Something's not right here. Something definitely has to change, as the Darkseer on top being solo is already level 6. And we'll put this point into Surge and Vacuum instead of Wall of Replica, which is a probably good idea as well, considering that in level 1 Wall of Replica, even though it lasts for 45 seconds, the damage it's only 60%, the damage output from the illusions, as opposed to 90% at level 3. So, wisely going for the Surge, as well as Vacuum for interrupts of TPs and for setups for the AoE slows that the Radiant team has. Shadow Beans taking a good stack over in his old NC. That's bringing him up to his maximum number of souls. That's really, really good damage output right now, as well as a double damage rune that he will use to push the lane out a little bit over in mid. But Dragonite will spot that DD rune, and playing it safe, will retreat a little bit further back. As mentioned before, we're approaching the 9th minute. Both mid lanes have their bottles as well as the power tread up and running. Ping's coming out onto the top lane. Juggernaut probably wanting to kill the Darkseer, with the support coming in from Tusk. Snowball will come in from the fog, but Exodia will surge away. The Snowball was actually on a creep. it's fine. We misclick once in a while. I usually hex creeps instead of heroes as well. So the smoke coming out here from the Radiant team, looking for the counter gank right now. Three heroes against two over in the top lane. They probably should focus on the Tusk. And they're looking to wrap around. The Vacuum will come in. The Dragon's Tail is being popped as well. Surge onto the Dragon Knight. A kill will come onto Tusk. Shadow Fiend TPs into the top lane as well. And we'll get the counter kill onto the Darkseer. But the Dragon Knight still wants to continue with the chase against the Juggernaut. But the Shadow Fiend just has too much damage and will be chasing against down these two heroes. Bottle Charge being interrupted there from that last auto attack right click. The Zeus still level 5, so unable to contribute to his global team fights. Thunder God's Wrath just not up yet. And AC will be going for drums. Bracer being Dyer's built up by him, while Shadow Fiend has completed his Aquila. So, as expected, as mentioned earlier, 12 minutes before the 12 minutes of the game, they've got Power Treads, Utility Item, as well as Wattle up and running. Both mids are doing really well so far at the current moment. And we're still waiting for to see if the Shadow Fiend will be going for the Yule Scepter build-up with the Spirit Bomb. Really low HP on both his heroes, just from jungling. It's been a really bad game for the Gyrocopter. He's being harassed out of lane by the Windrunner. He's unable to farm properly with the pressure being applied by the two support heroes as they rotate down into the Radiant's jungle. And to be quite honest with you, it's not looking too good for the Radiant team. The carry has been so far behind. They need to buy so much time for the Gyrocopter to actually farm up the necessity items. Radiant's and as things go, there's just attack. No way that the Gyrocopter can withstand the right-click damages coming out from the Juggernaut as well as the Shadow Fiend. Not just the right-clicks, but also the spell damage that can come out from Thunder God's Wrath as well.
Missing top.
Having a quick brief look over the XP graph, Radiant's it's just about 1,000 in the favor of the Dyer, and over in the gold graph, it's a little over 2,000. TP coming into Gyrocopter over the top lane. Looks like they're going to try to make something happen here, the tier 1 top lane, as four heroes from the Radiant are here over the top lane. Attack. And in the meantime, we've got three heroes of the Dyer in the Radiant's jungle. So, pretty much both teams taking each other's cooldown will come out onto the heroes. Look at Gyrocopter's isolated right there. Juggernaut will try to fight, but the Death Ward will kill him off. And like seriously on the Winter Wyvern should be looking to save up his carry, but will not be able to do so. Instead, the Shadow Queen is there with a Requiem of Soul, killing two! Gets a triple kill! And AC just trying to stand and fight, but will not be able to do so. Power shot as well, Ultra kill coming up from the Shadow Queen. That Requiem just did so much damage and slowed down all the heroes. Looking over to the fight recap, let's look at the damage. That's 2,375 damage done from the Requiem, as well as the three Shadow Races and his right clicks. That's just how big the Shadow Fiend is right now. 12 minutes into the game, does have 700 gold in the bank in addition to his Yasha, which will be coming over. So possibly a Manta style?
Missing top.
Not too sure. Might be just a casual Yasha as he Radiant's moves in transitions into a heavy right click hero. And the Winter Wyvern, quite poor, unable to even afford any wards coming out here. So Witch Doctor's also been doing his fair share of the warding. He's actually been able to afford his arcane boots right now. And they see that the Invis rune has been picked up from the Shadow Fiend and pinging it out against the Gyrocopter to retreat. And Gyrocopter will do so. 20 last hits.
Dire's bottom tower under attack.
I take back what I said. It's not a bad game for the Gyrocopter. It's an abysmal game for the Gyrocopter. Gyrocopter is a liability at this stage for the Radiant team, unless they're able to buy a lot of time for him. And now Darkseer going on a ramble on his own into the Dire jungle and will actually come across Dire's against Pain. Pain doesn't have much mana. Attack. Snowball will come in and they'll be looking to try to get into the Darkseer, but just out of range. Ice Shards blocking it off. I see. Oh, the Juggernaut ulti does come out, but too many heroes there, able to tank up all the hits from the Omni Slash. Oh, that's an Omni Slash being casted. Requiem of Soul also on cooldown right now. And this could be a sign for the Radiant team to just keep pushing and applying pressure onto the top lane. Walrus Punch immediately onto the Darkseer, but that's not much damage. Paralyzing cast coming onto one as well. Dragon Dragontail onto the Juggernaut as well. And the Shadow Fiend will TP to the two corpses of his teammates. And that's about 100 gold wasted on the TP from the Shadow Fiend. Should have just continued farming, continued pushing. There's no way he can defend this against four heroes here at the top lane. And that's definitely one tier one tower going down, especially with the corrosive breath coming out from the Dragon Knight. He's just going to tick down this tower really, really soon. They've got a siege creepy there as well to help things move along. And Pain has got his level 6, Radiant's level 8 now, my bad, attack. And will have the Thunder Radiant God's Wrath ready to call upon. My dear goodness, I'm sorry if I do sound tired, it's been quite a long day. As we see, the Shadow Fiend will be getting Exodia farming in his jungle. Darkseer, this is not your jungle. You'd better get out. Oh, that's some good jukes coming up from Exodia. Just dodges that raise. Will be pinged out, and the Juggernaut will be chasing. Tries to TP out, but... Oh, no. Trying to TP out in that situation is like trying to flap your arms when you're falling down. You can see your imminent death in front of you, so there's absolutely no reason for him to just try to TP. He just wasted about 100 gold. Should have just bought his items and just... accepted his fate right there.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
So the score, the kills right now being 6-8, 15 minutes into the game. Just looking at the items progression. Let's have a look over at the Dragon Knight. Will be making his way. So yep, there you go. The drums as mentioned. My bad. Shadow Shot coming into the creep over into the bottom lane. You reported the Windrunner is in too far. Right now, the homing missile will latch onto him and it's got too low HP anyway. Rocket Barrage will finish the Windranger off. Over into mid lane, there's a little bit more of a skirmish coming out. Tusk getting the eye shots, blocking out the Dragon Knight, who will actually look to pursue. Continue paralyzing Kask as well as Malik coming from Kuroki. Arctic Burn as well from the Winter Wyvern. That's a dead Tusk.
Ask not for whom the spell tolls.
That's a dead Tusk right there.
And it's in.
Oh, welcome and back, Brandon. You left me alone, you silly bugger.
I'm sorry, there was really a lot of in the reward.
Right, so anyway, just moving, as mentioned before, with the item progression of the Dragon Knight, we expected to see a Drums of Endurance, and there the Drums of Endurance has been completed. Does have 1,000 gold, so should be looking into that Ogre Club to make into his BKB. Darkseer will have his mechanism in roughly about 300 gold. Most likely going for the Guardian Greaves, as he does have the Arcane Boots already, while the Gyrocopter, as I mentioned before, has having a terrible game, terrible game, only has a Mask of Death to show for it. Koroki, on the other hand, does actually have an Orb of Venom. I want to look at the net worth. And Gyrocopter. Yep.
Testing.
Hello, hello, yes.
Is it more clear, right?
Yes,
is it more clear right now?
Yes, it's more clear right now. I definitely am able to hear you better, and I'm sure our spectators are also able to hear you better. Brendan.
17 minutes in at 16 kills. It's a very passive game. Yeah, what's up?
Would you like to give a shout out to Joyce Chan?
Hi.
Anyway, moving back with the game right now. It looks like the net worth, Shadow Fiend way up ahead in there, 9,000 in net worth. Juggernaut close behind with 6,000. And the Gyrocopter, as bad as a game as he did have right now, he's trying to recover, but he's just so far behind the Shadow Fiend that he can't deal effective damage. Just needs to stand back and try to hit his cooldowns as well as Flak Cannon and just hope he doesn't die. And now watch me whip on the Shadow Fiend. It's doing a really superb job. He has gone for the Sanjin Yasha and has the Ogre Club in his stash, looking to build forward into the Becca Bear.
One kill, one assist, and one death on Gyrocopter.
Look how many last hits he has.
Last hits. Oh, he did terribly in a safe lane, is it?
He did horribly in the safe lane. It wouldn't even be called a safe lane. It should be called Danger Lane. Even though they had two heroes backing me up. And the snowball's gonna come in. He's gonna pull in two heroes as well with him. And now AC's in trouble. Wall is pressed immediately. Shadow Fiend is being caught by the Golden Friend. Death One does come on. Rekwin doesn't come on in time. They're all tied. Thunder Cross Rask will hit, but the damage is being negated by that mechanism. Finally, the Omni Slash will be looking to come out. Will he cast it? Yes, he does, but it bounces over the creeps and he chases the Blade Tree, but there's no way for him to go, so he's just going to retreat back. AC is able to just chase them down with his Dragon's Breath, still has a healthy amount of HP. He will almost dive, and right now, the Paralyzing Cast will bounce between them and Maledict as well. Fade is in trouble. He's going to go down as well to the Dragon's Breath, and that's a terrible fight for the Dire Team's ends.
Oh, colors flying around, I can't even see what's happening.
I'm out of breath.
Get it? Breath.
Okay, anyway, AC will probably go down. Walrus Punch coming out. No, it gets stunned instead, and the health is just gonna be healed up by the Witch Doctor. There's no way you can kill him. Oh my god. Oh dear.
What was he thinking?
I really dropped just like Elder Titan that did down the game fight.
Oh yes, you're probably right. Elder Titan will actually do really, really good in this game. And they will deny the tier 1 tower.
Dire's middle tower has been denied.
So, we'll just wait for the XP graph and the gold graph to take into consideration the previous fight. And look at that, it's almost zero. And in fact, the net worth is slightly in favor of the Dire team.
Well, this game on a 20 marks with 22 kills is a very, very passive game, I must say.
Sorry, did you say Elder Titan?
Yeah. Elder Titan fits this game.
Elder Titan fits this game perfectly. Oh my god. I'm sorry. Moving back with the
Elder
game.
Elder Titan makes up. Alright.
Yeah, Elder Titan trying to deward Techie's ward. Not Techie's mind.
So Pain will be on warding duty. Don't really understand why he needs a sentry ward when he's actually got the lightning bolt as a skill, but instead we'll just plant a sentry ward just to be sure over there. Double damage rune over on the bottom rune, and will be picked up by the Shadow Fiend, who does have 1.5k gold in the bank. I wonder what his next item is going to be. Juggernaut does have his Mask of Madness, and in comparison, when we look over to the Radiant team, the Gyrocopter does have his Helm of Dominator, but has not dominated the creep yet? Yeah, he's not dominated the creep yet. He really should take advantage
and use that creep for stacking, but looks like he'll just gonna keep it on cooldown and not use it. And it's a weird thing. Windranger doesn't have the force stuff, but help me, Zenz. What item is he building into? Oh, Aghanim Scepter, of course. Oh, look, God. So the Windranger will be looking to go for an Ag Scepter. Does have the point booster. It's just about 800 away from his Ag Scepter, so that's a good timing for an offlaner. Over onto the Zeus, 1000 gold. Has his arcanes as well as sentries. BKB almost done here from the Shadow Fiend. I beg your pardon?
Who do you favor in this team?
I favor the Elder Titan.
Radiant or Gaia? Thanks. Very much. Elder Titan wins the games.
Oh, looks like it's a smoke coming out here from the Dire team. Sorry to interrupt you. The smoke's coming in from the Dire team. Pain clearing the way. They're going to move into the Radiant jungle. They smell blood right now. They're like sharks in the water, and there's a dead fish that they're just about to circle and kill. But they are going the wrong way. But it looks like Pain will get his smoke dispelled. Does he spot out Koroki? No, not just yet. Koroki playing very smartly. The smoke will dispel, but they will not react fast enough. Koroki gets back into the fog, but now Ace is in trouble. Windrun coming up with Windranger. BKB charge comes out, so it negates the Shackle Drop. Koroki in the vacuum and does what as well. It's a disaster for the Radiant. Sorry, it's a disaster for the Dire team.
Radiant's top tower is under
and
attack.
The Radiant team, just like that, managed to win a team fight really, really well. That's some really good fog play there from Koroki. Pardon?
Oh, I really didn't notice there was a Koroki in the game. Koroki, to be exact.
That's right, Koroki.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Now they're just gonna keep going, and they are going to be on the steps of the Dire.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Dire's structures are fortified.
Ice shards will block three heroes into their base, and the Omni Slash will come out, but there's so many creeps right there. Mechanism will negate the damage right now. The Snowball does come out. Cooldown will hit on three heroes. BKB come out from the Shadow Fiend. Requiem of Souls will be coming out. Three heroes are in close vicinity. That's Destino 3, as well as the Thunder God's Wrath. Static Link doing so much damage right now, and the Omni Slash, pardon me, the Juggernaut with his final right click will get the kill. Triple kill from the Shadow Fiend, and Koroki does get a double kill on the side of the Radiant, but they're trying to chase. Oh, the power shot does spot Exodia. He'll be looking, trying to TP out, but blinks away just in time. The fights have been going really, really back and forth now, Zenz.
Exactly. I mean, Radiant team went aggressive on top of the tower. They didn't see Dire team is coming up. Yep.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Radiant, I think that's an overextension by the Radiant team. They were too confident that they had won the previous team fight that they thought that they could replicate Radiant's the results again, but this time the Dire fallen. Team actually had the high ground.
And when you look at it, it's very difficult
to
actually.
Did Shadow Fiend went for Shenji Yasha or BKB first?
He went for the SNY first. He went for the SNY first. The BKB was just completed about 8 minutes ago. As you can see, that BKB still has 9 seconds on his charge.
Oh, alright.
Well, I don't know about you, Zenz, but I'm pretty drained, pretty tired from casting today. It's been officially 12 hours since we started the cast.
Yeah, exactly, man. Since 11.
Do we have any other games after this?
Yep, we have games after this. We have 4 more games after this.
We have 4 more games after this. I think I'm gonna die.
Come on, Inferno, show me what you got.
Show you what I got. Yeah. Come over to my room, I'll show you what I got. Hey, Zenz, tell me a pickup line.
Robotofire and Neurogaming was gonna be for the next game in the time.
What's the next game? Sorry, I'll just update it on
Roboto game and
Roboto games and
New World Gaming, I'm sorry.
And
New World Gaming.
And New World Gaming, so
Definitely one to watch right there. As looking through the item progression, so Juggernaut looking to build into his would you say that's a Scuddy? It does have his ultimate op. Not too sure. Might be looking to go into the Manta as well. As the Ag Scepter is 40 gold away from being completion onto the Wind Ranger. Shadow Fiend, as mentioned before, does have 3.2 thousand gold. Might be looking into the Desolator or the Daedalus. Has got his BKB, so relatively tanky. Well, should be looking to get his damage items. Zeus, 1,004 gold. Possibly looking towards a Blink Dagger for better repositioning in the fights, but really quite dependent as well on which direction Pain wants to take him. If he wants more damage, he could always try to go for that Ag Scepter or even push into a Refresher, but it's going to be difficult. He's not going to get the space to farm. Most of the farm priority is actually going to go to the Juggernaut as well as the Shadow Fiend. Oh dear. That does not look good. Just to mention, the Tusk is 0, 8, and 10.
He's died 8 times.
Alright, I see what I'm saying. A pickup line? Alright, I'll give you a pickup line. Inferno. Do you like Cherry?
Do I like Cherry?
Yeah. Yep.
Yes, I do like Cherry.
Yeah, you know, I want. Yeah, because I want to pop it.
Oh my god. You did not say that on live stream, did you? Oh, you did. Well done, Zenz. Well done. Oh my god. Oh, you're terrible. Anyway, moving back again. Oh my god. Yeah, talking about the item progression over on the Tusk, he's only got his face boots as well as bottle, so it doesn't really have much of an item progression, so to speak. Maybe he's been hard support, but then again, it's Zeus that's been warding. Yeah, it is the Zeus he's been warding. So the Tusk really just suffering from the 8 deaths that he's had so far. Onto the Radiant team. Winter Wyvern does have the casual cloak, so to speak, just to reconnecting. Well,
looking at the EXP grassings and gold grassings, like everything is favorous on the Dire team, which is GTS, go to sleep.
Yeah, I might just go to sleep, since might not be able to make it for the next games. I'll definitely try to cast them, of course, but of course, we hope that viewers actually get a pleasurable experience and not some person just randomly yawning into the mic every 5 seconds. Pain is in a very interesting position, does have an Invis rune, and he's just gonna scout around in the Radiant jungle. Will be pinged out is the mid lane, the Winter Wyvern, so they're probably looking to catch him. The Windrun Shackle Shot misses onto the creep. Oh, that's 2 skills misses in a row. Arctic Bird will bring him over to safety. And he does drop down to 200 HP points, but it's all fine as long as he survives. There was so little investment into that gank on the Dire team. All they needed to do was just one shackle, and already Winter Wyvern's brought down to about 1/8 of his health. Top lane.
I would really say.
Yeah, sorry.
Today. Sorry. Yeah, I will say first.
I was just noting on the fact that how the Radiant team is actually the one leading the kills, but as you mentioned, the EXP and the gold graph show a biasness, or rather favors, towards the Dire team.
I would say I would favor the Dire team because, you know, looking at the graph, there are three-man hitters, even though there's a Winter Wyvern, but Winter Wyvern only can only call and press one person every each 15 or 14 seconds. He can't cover all his teammates.
Well, that's quite true, but you mustn't also forget the fact that the Winter Wyvern actually does have the Winter's Curse, and considering that the heroes on the Dire team are actually quite heavy hitters, if he casts a proper Winter's Curse and the Juggernaut and Shadow Fiend's caught in it, that's a huge amount of damage.
True, that's very true.
I miss seeing Crystal Maidens being picked up. I always think the Crystal Maiden ulti is such an incredible ultimate to actually land properly in a team fight. Just needs so much positioning skill as well as timing. I love seeing Enigma too.
Yeah, some Wombo combo would make a trick.
Exactly. Enigmas with their black holes, since you like black holes so much. Ping's coming out over into mid lane. Watch me whip. Just gonna try to chase AC back with harassing him with right clicks. But of course, the Winter Wyvern's there to respond. Tusk comes out with the ice shot, but will not block it off well enough. Doesn't have enough mana right now to actually try and commit with a Snowball Falcon. But Omni Slash immediately coming out of the Dragon Knight. That's the Dragon Knight taking out the fight. Cooldown will come down and hit two heroes. One hero, rather, as the Cold Embrace will come out, but immediately the Winter Wyvern will drop down. The Juggernaut's damage is just so much right now at this point. Rocket Barrage from the Gyrocopter Winter Wyvern as well.
Thunder God's Wrath from the Zeus will finally come down. The Gyrocopter is caught in no man's land right now. Buyback coming from the Dragon Knight, and if he dies, it will be a dieback, but they will choose not to pursue him any further. One thing I wanted to note there, Zenz, was the very weird positioning of the Radiant team. They came this way, and they ran up here when the rest of the team was still gathered here. They should have just stayed on the high ground and wait for the Dire team to actually come over and push. But instead, they started to split up. They got chased, they got isolated, and that way, the Juggernaut saw the opportunity for the Omni Slash and immediately casted it. As we hit the 30 minute mark, we are at 19 kills to 18, one kill in favor of the Radiant, but it doesn't feel that way because the Dire have a little bit more control over the team fights, and the XP graph as well as the gold graph definitely proves it. They're pinging out Roshan right now. They don't have vision, but they're gonna smoke. And let's see what's gonna happen. AC is the bait, and Illusion Rune gets caught, Exodia. Shackle shot coming onto the Gyrocopter, but will not latch on. Now watch me whip. That's a Shadow Fiend. Will be chasing up into the high
Radiant's
ground, but will
tower
actually retreat, and
attack.
Both teams will reset their positions.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Well, since Radiant team is got to be back, it will be a good opportunity for the team now to get a rush. Since Smoke is on cooldown.
Well, you gave a very good point of the Smoke being on cooldown, and definitely we've seen the Dire team straight away move into the rush pit. The Healing Ward doing so much work right now.
Regeneration!
Doing the damage is so slow. The Roshan's attack speed is so slow. Skadi that we picked up from the Juggernaut. So we predicted it correctly, it was a Skadi that's coming out from the Juggernaut. And right now they're just gonna chase over into the high ground right now. Shackle shot will get the double hero shackle on this clash as well. We'll immediately bring down the Witch Doctor. Thunder God's Wrath from this use as well. So much damage. Vacuum wall! Really, really good, but all heroes are so low right now on the Radiant team. Darkseer, there's not much he can do, but the Gyrocopter is doing so much damage with his BKB. But just right click from the Shadow Fiend is just too much. It's a 3-for-3.
Double kill.
Oh no, he gets a kill
there
with
are
the SF. He gets a kill with the SF illusion that came up from the wall of the replica, so that's a 4-for-3, just the Shadow Fiend surviving. And I think that's not a bad fight.
As you predicted, I would say MVP will go through Winter Raven. It was a very good Winter Curse. He shut down Wind Ranger for like what, 2 seconds, not even one. That was the most critical point. They lose the fight because there was no any hitter on the Dire team.
Oh, you're absolutely correct right there.
Dire's middle Dire team is under attack.
Just lost so much of their Dire's damage source.
Oh, Blink. Was that a Blink from the Darkseer? I think it was. The Darkseer has a Blink Dagger? Yeah, Darkseer has a Blink Dagger. So right now, AC is just retreating from that mid lane in his dragon form. Not much damage actually coming out from the Dragon Knight. He's just being such an annoying nuisance in terms of the tank as well as the Frost Breath Splash attack and the Corrosive Breath. But other than that, it's not dealing so much damage. He doesn't have any damage items on him.
A good damage item goes on Juggernaut would be good, considering there's a lot. Death Solitaire would be good, considering DK Dragon Knight has a lot of armor.
The Witch Doctor is this 600 gold away from his Ag's Scepter, and they're spotting out the rotation coming out here by the ward, and Tusk will move forward, snowball immediately onto the Winter Wyvern, who will Arctic Burn over the trees and the Glimmer Keep as well, and they will not proceed any further. No detection over on the side of the Dire. So they are just going to retreat and reset. Does get the shackle latched on? Nope, he doesn't. No trees there for Exodia to be latched onto. And they're just going to push down here over on the bottom tier 2 tower. They're just going to pressure. Possibly the next fight will be over this tower.
But it's very surprising, Steve.
Right now, now watch me whip on the SF. It says right clicking onto Blink Forward, Vacuum as well as Wall of Replica, but Exodia is immediately latched onto a Shackle. Requiem of Souls does come on, and the Darkseer will disappear just like that. Arctic Burn as well as the Winter Curse coming up from the Winter Wyvern.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Surviving through all that damage, I was going to say that the Witch Doctor had a good ultimate there for a full channel duration, but it was cut short. He was just brought down so quickly by the right clicks of the Juggernaut.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
It wasn't a good fight for Radiant team. They should have give the tower and just fight it on the uphill.
Oh, now that's a complete team fight with no buybacks at all, so that's at least two Raxes. No, one Rax. And tier 2 top. Oh, I think it's gonna go for the throne. It's 40 seconds till the Dragon Knight comes up, and they will not be going for the throne. Instead, they'll be trying to push this mid tower, but the backdoor protection will actually prevent them from taking it down. They should be focusing on the top lane, so some really, really interesting decisions here coming out from the Dire team. There you go, finally they'll ping up that top tower. They will focus their attention over
Radiant's
there.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Radiant's structures are fortified.
Alright, sorry for disconnect with you. There was some difficulty on the source 2.
Looks like Watch Me Whip is just gonna walk casually onto the high ground and just right click away on the Winter Wyvern as well as the Darkseer and the tower. He's just gonna ignore everything. Homing missile will come out, targeted onto the Zeus, but it's quickly. Oh, Vacuum onto the Shadow Fiend, paralyzing Kask as well, but the follow up. Maledict does hit, and the paralyzing Kask will bounce between the two of them. Iron Shell will go, and the Wall of Replica as well. So much damage from the illusion of the Shadow Fiend, actually. Shackle Shot will actually prevent the illusion from caving, but that's just how much damage right now the Shadow Fiend does. Even his illusions, which is doing 90% damage, is just doing so much right click attacks over onto the Dire team. If the Darkseer goes for his Ag Scepter, that will be very, very painful.
Painful. That, like I said, I would favor the Dire team. Looking at their picks.
Well, that's quite true. But right now, how it stands is 36 minutes into the game,
The gyrocopter will be building towards his MKB, I think. It's got one javelin. And I think it would be better if he actually bought Demon Edge. A BKB pop there by the gyrocopter.
BKB.
Oh my god, what's happening with this game? Yeah. I'm getting too tired. Anyway, that's a 7-second BKB. So that's 48 seconds without the BKB. He's gonna have to be really, really careful. And the Radiant team have got to avoid fights right now until the BKB actually comes back off cooldown. Oh my goodness. Anyway,
by the way, Shadowfin just pick up a certain hit.
What? Oh! Blink forward as well as Shackle onto AC. The damage from the Juggernaut onto the Dragon Knight is real. The damage is real, and they're gonna go headlong into this mid lane.
Seems like Juggernaut is going for Radiant or even a Divine Rapier.
Oh, the Juggernaut does have the Sacred Relic already up in his inventory. Sense, what is the first place prize for Dota 2? Is it 3,900?
Price pro?
What is the first place price for Dota 2?
First price 2,000, first price 1,000, and also third price.
Oh, that's
800.
And Exodia here trying to do as much damage as he can, and will be shackled up. The mechanism has to be popped. Omni Slash will be cast and will bring down the Witch Doctor immediately, as well as the Winter Worm. That's a 2-for-1 right now from the Juggernaut's Omni Slash. And the BKB of the Gyrocopter goes off to save his own skin. And I think that's it. I think that's GG. There's no way they can come back from this right now. It's just too much of a deficit in terms of experience. It's more than 25,000. And the gold as well is definitely more than 25,000 in terms of net worth. Shadowfiend had an amazing game, and the Gyrocopter possibly could have helped his team win if he actually had a better time in the early game.
I think that's the game.
Yep, fountain farming. GG, finally being called.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
And Brandon, I think that's...
I think that's it. Are you gonna go to sleep?
Don't think I'll be able to actually contribute much in terms of casting anymore. Are you gonna take over the cast?
No, I'm not gonna do the cast. You know my voice. I can't even cast a single thing. I can't even talk.
Alright, so to everyone that's watching, what time are we starting off tomorrow?
Tomorrow as CSGO will be starting at 10, and for Dota it all depends on the current Dota 2 Reborn servers. As if it's been delayed, then we will be starting in 5, 6, or even 7.
Alright, thank you so much, Brendan. I don't think I'll be able to join you. My voice is on its last legs already, and I've got to keep this up until Thursday. So, good luck for the next future games, and to all our spectators, we'll meet again tomorrow at 10 o'clock in the morning.
Alright, see you in Inferno. Alright,
see you, Brendan. Bye-bye.
Right.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think that's it for me for today. My voice is starting to crack a little bit, and it's been about 12 and a half hours of my cast non-stop. Join us again tomorrow at 10 o'clock for Counter-Strike, and the Dota 2 games will also be dependent on how many games we actually finish. So don't forget to follow us on our Facebook page, Curtain Gaming Championship, for updates as to the standings, as well as fixtures that you can expect to catch all the games in. So thank you so much for following me up until now. It's been amazing having all of you here, and look forward to seeing you join me tomorrow for another day of Curtain Gaming Championship. Have a good night and stay safe.